Good evening, everyone. I'm Eric Dewey.
And I'm fucking ready!
And this is epic!
Woo!
And we are socially awkward. And
hey, we're just like most women's
periods. I thought that would get us pumped for the show today. Oh,
that was a man. That was a little throwback. That reminded me of Megadeth.
Yeah. I found that on Jamendo. It's Black Star, the track called Scream, obviously.
Fuck yeah, I knew the song was track. I knew the song was called Scream.
It had to be called Scream. Shit, it couldn't have been called anything else.
he really loved saying Scream.
Yeah.
No, it was
he
a good
loved
track,
screaming
though.
Scream. Yeah. I know, I'm not usually a big metalhead, but every now and then. I really like the guitar work in there.
No, yeah,
that's what I mean, man.
It reminded me of bass pedal going. Nice.
Old Megadeth, a little bit of little sprinkle and dab of Metallica, older Metallica in there.
Yeah. So
I would like to think that those are probably some of their influences.
They're like, "Nope, our influences they're like, is Papa Roach."
Papa Roach.
They're like, "Who's Metallica?" I'm influenced by the great Frank Sinatra and Celine Dion.
Whoop de doo in Hickory Dock. Don't you wanna scream?
The greats. Frank Sinatra, Grace Kelly, Godsmack.
and I'm out.
No. Never that. Never ever that. Guys, do you know what today's date is?
It's Friday.
It is Friday.
Gotta get down on my day.
The 11th of September.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
So we had talked briefly before the show about this is one of the only times that our show is going to specifically land on this date. It's 14 years later.
Wow.
So
14 years ago, Matthew and I were still in high school.
Yep. This is accurate.
Yeah. Do you guys still remember where you were and what happened when you first heard about it?
Yeah.
I was coming into work. Coming into work off of the late shift.
I was just fresh out of the mine.
Yeah. Well, back in my day, we used to get out of the mines about 6 a.m. I think things were just breaking, at the beginning of the school day. I think class started, 8:30.
It was pretty early in the morning for us.
I was
here in Arizona.
I was at school. I was in English class because I did zero hour.
Yeah. Oh.
So, and that started at 7. So I was in class when the whole thing was happening. We watched it. It was nuts.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was working, so I still remember because it was nuts. I didn't listen to the radio on my way to work at the time. I had a CD player in my car that could play MP3s off of a CD.
I had
a CD full of MP3s that I totally legally purchased.
Prime technology of that
era.
Yeah, and that era.
Man.
Fuck yeah,
dude,
buddy.
That was awesome.
You were living large.
Hell yeah, it was aftermarket deck.
Man, look at Eric. Man.
Like a Sony Power something.
When
I don't know what the fuck it was.
Sony Power something.
Eric, so when did you fall from grace? you were living large.
3 days grace. Another band.
Yeah. It was a piece of shit car, but I put a nice stereo in it because I'm like, I got to drive around in this piece of crap. I might as well have a good sound system.
Yeah. Live that life of luxury.
Well, the deck was nice. The speakers I bought at the dirt mall. The old Phoenix Swap Mart.
The good old dirt mall.
Good old dirt mall. They were like Rockford Fosgates or something like that.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
So not quite Rockford Fosgates, but the logo looks somewhat similar.
Yeah.
And they were about $5 a piece.
There you go.
And they hit pretty hard, until I blew them out in a month or so.
Yeah.
But,
So you were working.
Plus I had like this cheap ass amp that I had crossed over and pushing way too much amperage for these stupid little piece of shit tens that I bought. Anyways, back in the day.
So you're working.
So I got to work.
Okay, yeah.
And immediately I walk into work. I'm working in a call center for Verizon Wireless at the time. And I walk into work and immediately I can just send there's just over the whole place. I'm like, what the fuck? Like, normally there's people bantering back and forth. There's people talking. There's people walking around with coffee or, whatever. No, everybody is at their desks. Everybody's focused. There's not even a high call volume. I look at the calls. I'm like, man, it's usually a bit busier right around this time. Don't have many calls in queue. And so I sit down. I get to my desk, sign in, whatever. I still haven't heard anything yet. Haven't seen any bit of news, heard anything. I'm just looking around. And everybody's, really focused on their own thing. I'm like, man, that's weird. First call I get is some guy who had his phone disconnected for not paying his bill. And he's like, I need to have my phone service right now. I'm like, oh, sir, I'd be happy to help you out. I just need a payment of at least blah, blah, blah. He's like, no, you don't understand. I'm in the military. Because of our situation right now, I need to have my phone on. And I'm like, fuck situation are you talking about? I'm like,
what the hell
okay,
are you
well,
talking about?
I work for the phone company, and you know, because of my situation, the fact that you haven't paid your bill, I'm like, I didn't get really snarky with them, but I was still like,
yeah.
I'm like, dude, you got to pay your bill if you want your phone service. I'm like, I can't do that. You know, that's not the way this works.
Yeah.
I'm like, if you have an emergency situation, you can always dial 911 from your phone. You know, I'm like, I don't understand what you're talking about. So after, you know, and he doesn't really tell me. He just gets mad and hangs up. And I'm like, what the fuck is he on about? So I'm like, all right, CNN.com. Let's see what's going on. And the first picture on CNN.com is from down the street from the World Trade Center towers. As the it was actually taken as the first building was collapsing, and I still remember because my first thought I'm looking at this picture going, this is fake, this is a screenshot from a movie, because it looked like a screenshot from Godzilla or something. It's people running down the street and looking over their shoulders at the towers collapsing, just piles of dust and shit, and I was like, what the this has got to be fake, right? This is bullshit.
Well, that's kind of how I felt when we were watching it in class, because obviously we got no work done that day.
Yeah, that was
a
like
whole day.
That like, was like a free day.
Every class was just, you know, news coverage.
We ended up having to do more work at work that day because they ended up, like, three of our other call centers in the country were near airports. Mm. Like, one of our biggest call centers was actually in Hawaii, and it was, like, right next to the airport. So they're like, no, anything anywhere close to an airport at all gets shut down. And then they told people, if you feel that you need to leave for personal reasons, you can leave. And so a bunch of people left, and so those of us who did stay, because I'm like, I mean, fuck, I got to work. You know, I need the paycheck. It wasn't like paid time off. It was like, you can take the day, but
you're not
So I'm like, I guess I'll stay. And we were one of the only call centers still active, so we started getting all the calls.
But like when the, you know, you're watching it, and like you see the plane go in, and like the building's all smoking and stuff like that. And like you're watching news coverage about it, and all of a sudden the other plane comes in and just rams right into the other one, like live on television.
Oh, yeah. And it's so nuts because the news anchors don't know shit. They're like,
you're like,
something's happened, but because they're not seeing it as clearly. Yeah. They're seeing a little tiny screen like far away, and they're like, oh shit, something's happened, but I'm not sure what because they haven't gotten the feed yet. Yeah.
And that was the craziest thing, to like just see it. Like all of a sudden you just hear a plane, and then it comes into like to view, and you know, it's just like,
there were all those other videos online that people had taken,
from
balconies, like different angles of it happening.
It was crazy with that.
And then, so then you're watching that, and then all of a sudden the South Tower just starts to, like, it just goes. And you're like, fuck!
Yeah.
And all this is happening on real time. Like, you're watching all this, and then after that, the next one goes, and you're like, holy cow. Like,
Because we slowly, like throughout the entire day, you slowly started getting more and more reports of what finally was happening. Because it's like, I think it was like probably 10 o'clock our time, maybe sooner than that. But then we're like, the second tower was hit. And then we just find out that two other planes were hijacked. Like one went for the Pentagon, and the other one was taken down by the actual passengers because they found out what was actually going on.
Yeah.
But it was just like, it was so weird. And then just, I remember that entire, like, what, maybe 2 weeks, 3 weeks of that? Just people were like, just, you couldn't even watch the news anymore because it was just depressing of everything and just the body count and just all that kind of stuff.
It was crazy. It was crazy to watch. And
it was weird just being
in real time. Like, fuck.
And it was really weird for us being at school because that happened, and I think we were all seniors. Mm-hmm. And you're turning 18, so you're like, oh, crap. Is the draft going to come back? Like, what's going to happen here kind of thing?
Yeah,
I would hope so because we did graduate together.
Like, yes.
Yeah.
But yeah, no, that was a really weird day. I think the weirdest thing was, I think I went hiking after school or whatnot, and not a single plane. Like, you know, everything was grounded though.
Yeah.
It was like the weirdest. Just sitting on, like, just not seeing a single plane in the sky.
It's weird how used to those that you get.
Yeah,
like, you don't even realize it most of the time unless they're like right over you, or like I work next to the Scottsdale airport, so every now and then like I've tuned out most of the airplanes that come through, but every now and then like one of the big military jets will come through and that thing shakes our whole building, and it's like, so that I noticed.
Yeah, that's like me outside when I'm like smoking on our break, because since we're not that far from the airport, you see the planes coming in and everything like that.
Yeah.
So it's just like, especially today when we saw one go by, like everyone just kind of stopped us all like, fuck, remember?
It was like, really, today? And then we get that stupid shooter on the freeway.
That's the new thing.
You know
what thing here in Arizona?
Like, someone brought up something. I forget who was saying it, but they said like everyone keeps thinking it's somebody from like who's off the freeway. What if it's somebody actually on the freeway driving?
It almost has to be because, or maybe not on the freeway, but on the cross streets.
Yeah.
Because either that or it's more than one person because they're literally so close to each other, like time-wise, mm-hmm. yeah. but so far apart, you know, several miles apart. So it's not somebody just, you know, oh, I'm going to camp right here, I'm going to shoot somebody, and then I'm going to walk down the street 5 miles. No, it's somebody's got to be moving pretty quick. There's well, oh, man. Now, it's been, whatever you do, don't read the comments on the news stories about
oh,
this.
Oh, yeah.
I lost so many brain cells yesterday because I made the mistake of going jumping in and trying to read some of the comments. And it's a bunch of people who have seen one too many episodes of Criminal Minds trying to profile this. One person like even like broke it down. Like they were like serious, like, hey, look at me. I'm freaking Dr. Reed right now. Look, oh, this has to be
Dr. Reed. I would have gone with Columbo.
Here's well, he's not in Criminal Minds. I was going with the Criminal Minds out.
I'm going with you. I was trying to be like,
I was
well,
sticking with my original analogy.
This doesn't add up.
So it's hilarious because she's going off on this whole long diatribe. Just, oh, I think it's got to be a adult male between 24 and 43 because this type of crime takes patience, and you only get that kind of patience with age, so it's definitely not a teen. You know, but what's funny is they're going on to this whole thing about how smart they are to figure this all out. Like, every third word is misspelled. You know, it's like, oh, it's definitely an adult male between male spelled like, you know, the mail that you get from the postman. Between the ages of 23 and 42,
cops are like, right, we're on the lookout for
probably
a post-it note.
Caucasian, not even close to how you spell Caucasian.
Well,
just like every third word was misspelled or like completely just wrong. And I'm like,
yeah, well,
so dumb right
people
now.
People need to be careful though, because remember the last time there was that sniper back in like, I think it was probably back in 2002, maybe 2003, that was like either in Chicago or it was like
Washington, D.C. one?
Yeah, it was the van driving around and everyone was like, oh, it's got to be this, got to be that. And then they finally catch the people and like, I forget what comedian was saying it, but he's at the Great City. He's all like, we all thought it was a white guy. It was one of us. Like kind of thing. Yeah, he's like, it was a brother. I didn't see that coming. Some scary shit.
Yeah, that was crazy too. The whole, because D.C. shut down.
Yeah,
I think the biggest difference with that was because people were dying. Whoever's doing the shooting here either is really good at aiming and is not trying to hurt people, or sucks at aiming. Because so far, nobody has been seriously hurt. The only, from what I understand, the only person who's been injured at all was a baby who was in the back seat of a car that got cut by some glass that came through.
Yeah.
I don't think anybody's actually been hit by
a
bullet.
Because that's the only thing I can think of. Someone's just like driving and they're not even paying attention. They're just shooting.
Well, I remember that too because I was listening to KTAR that day, and Bruce St. James was on, and they actually had one of the Arizona council people on that. Like, they all got escorted into like buildings, and like all these like government people were in all these different buildings around like the Capitol building. And they were talking to him, and they're like, we really don't know what's going on. We know that there's been, like, multiple shots. And this was the most recent one that happened, like, maybe 2 or 3 years ago. I don't think this was the sniper one. This was a different one.
Okay.
Are you talking about here?
No, this is in D.C.
Oh, okay, okay.
And, it ended with, like, a car chase and, like, yeah, it was pretty wild. But, like, KTAR was, Bruton St. James show was covering it. It was nuts to hear, like. Yeah. They're talking like, you know, real time about the shit.
It's weird the people, like I said, I was reading the comments and that was a mistake, but there
Matt's
was
word
some
of the
people
day is real time. I think I've said it like 6 times since we've talked.
No, that's actually the name of the episode tonight is real time.
Real time with Matthew Renfro. Yeah, no, there's a lot of people are making random theories like, oh, don't be texting and driving because that's probably what the shooter's looking for. They're probably looking for people who are on their phones or people who are weaving in and out of traffic or people who are speeding or this, that. Maybe they're looking for people who are driving normally. Yeah. Maybe they're punishing the people who don't do those things. You don't know. Nobody knows.
The only shitty part that's going to happen is when they do, like, I know if it's a guy literally driving or somebody else. I just made the joke. If it was actually somebody from far away, like, shooting, they're going to shoot the wrong person. It's going to be, like, some ex-Marine sniper. He's going to be like, I was about 40 clicks out. He just, like, stops his car, gets out, put out a sniper rifle, and then you see a guy just, like, fall out, like, from a tree. He's like, he's done, and just gets out his car and takes off.
Kind of thing.
What is it, like CSI? Yeah!
Maybe.
Yeah, he's like, snipe this. But yeah, that's that. And that just started like what, like a week ago?
It's been
like a couple
days.
Weeks. Cause, yeah, I was about to say it's been like 10 or 11 days.
That's just nuts.
10 accounts over 11 days.
Yeah. We just can't have anything.
What's really crazy is how many people like don't notice or like they don't realize what's happened. That's why I think, that's why I don't necessarily think it's somebody just like randomly shooting out their car, because you're going to hear that.
Yeah,
if somebody's right next to you, and plus it's going to do more damage to the car. These are obviously strikes from further distance.
That's what I'm like. That's what I'm just not getting. It's like, I don't know.
But people they're just like, I don't. The one person said, I thought I hit a rock or something, and then when I got out of my car, I noticed that, oh wait, there's a hole in my car that obviously looks like a bullet hole.
Yeah.
Where other people were like immediately like, I think I got shot at. What the hell? It's nuts. I totally forgot. I went to the baseball game. I went to the Diamondbacks game on Wednesday.
Yeah.
And I totally forgot. I just jump on the 10, start heading into the stadium, and then I was like, oh, fuck me. I'm on the 10. What the fuck am I doing?
Yeah.
But I like start to just like seriously get worried. I'm like, should I slouch?
I thought it was more West Valley 10, though.
It for the most part, but it has gone as far east as 24th Street.
Okay.
So it was definitely, you know.
Yeah.
Definitely
you guys,
in
like,
that
I can't go
area.
Any farther. My, you know. My ankle bracelet won't let me go to a certain distance. So
right. It's so weird. Yeah, and for some reason he does have a hard-on for the 10 because he's only shot people on the 10 and on the 51 near the 10. He hasn't gone as far east as the 101 or as far west as the other 101.
It'll be interesting once they finally find the person or individuals doing it.
Yeah, well, they think...
I just hope they have a good story. Just be like, man, I was bored.
I got these guns, and I was so bored just sitting there looking at all my guns, thinking, man, I wish I could shoot these guns.
I mean, who knows what it is? It could just be a crazy person, or maybe
I heard the government was going to take my bullets. Yeah.
You never really know.
Well, that's the one thing. Yeah. Like, I actually did kind of like the theory of, like, maybe it's some guy who, like, lost his daughter or his wife or something like that because somebody was texting and driving on the 10 and crashed into her or something, you know, some shit like that. And so he's literally up there looking for people, like, oh, you motherfucker on your phone. Pew!
Eric's, like, bringing like, it up. Giving him a Dark Knight background or something like that is all like, jeez. My family was taken from me.
I would, you know, it would
so
suck.
So I need to take from them.
But at the same time, at least it would allow me to make more sense of it. Because if it really ends up just being Cletus who was bored and had a couple of guns handy, I'm going to be severely disappointed. I'd be like, you fucking nutball.
I'm not the shooter the I-10 needs.
Next time you
right
really
now.
Feel like firing your gun, just put it in your mouth and pull the fucking trigger. Because seriously.
Or go to a shooting range.
Oh, yeah, or that.
Yeah.
You know, you could. There's facilities.
Okay, there's other ways you can get your anger out with guns. I don't know why you went with death first, Eric, but maybe,
what I really
maybe you need a backstory.
These people who they know that their end game is going to be to shoot themselves, and they decide they need to take out as many people as they can with them. It's like, no, you know what? If you have that thought, start with yourself.
Yeah, that's
like,
your,
seriously.
It's like your choose your own adventure book, and instead of going through your elaborate book, just go to the second page and go, oh, you killed yourself.
Oh. I always ended up.
But we'll see
what
happens with that. But yeah, it's just been ridiculous. But all the memes have been coming out, which are pretty weird. That's probably them.
Yeah, it's crazy. We might have some guests. So
there's a knock on our door.
Yeah, so we can stop talking about this serious bullshit and have some fun conversations.
Hello, people.
Hello.
Welcome.
Come on in.
Eric, Matthew.
Hi.
Solid.
We got
nice you. To meet you
we
guys.
Got you over here on the couch. Just.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I need to grab one, too.
Hey, do it.
Grab it. You need anything?
No, I'm good.
You're good?
I'm good.
Did you bring the bottle?
No.
Oh.
I didn't quite go that far. But I did fill up the cup pretty high, though.
There you go. For sure.
None of this snooty, I can only fill my wine glass up to one-third of the way. No.
So you're doing the wine because it's better for you?
I don't know if it's really better for me. It's just less carbs, and I drank a lot of beer last night, so
yeah,
I should stick with it for now. There you go. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
For sure.
But yeah, so no. Plus I like it. So
yeah, for sure. I've enjoyed when it's been brought over for L2 intake. So
this one was nice. I went to the Albertsons pick up the beer, and they had this one on clearance for $4. It's normally like $11. So I'm like, ooh, that's usually outside of my price range for wine. So
yeah. Nice.
Normally more than $7 for a bottle. Fuck that.
No way. I ain't got time for that shit.
Yeah. No, I have to keep my taste for cheap wine because I've ruined my taste for cheap beer. I can't drink cheap beer anymore. I've ruined my taste for cheap whiskey. I can't drink cheap whiskey anymore.
You fucking snob.
So that's why I'm keeping my taste for cheap wine. That way I have one really cheap. It's like I can buy a box of wine and thoroughly enjoy it. No problem.
You became.
I can't buy a plastic bottle of scotch and enjoy it. It won't work.
Dang, man.
Not anymore.
That sucks for you.
It does, because sometimes I just really want some scotch, but I really don't want to pay $35 for a bottle.
For sure.
But anything under about the $30 price range for a bottle of scotch is going to be some nasty shit.
You know, sometimes you just got to bear
down.
You
can catch it on sale sometimes. You can catch like some Chivas on sale for like $22 or something like that. That's, that's all right. You can adjust those stands, too. Like, you don't have to...
Just sounds like you've gotten very snobbish, man. I feel like you should move up to
Scottsdale. Well, Eric's also, like, 80 years old now.
I work in Scottsdale, so maybe that's what happened.
That you do.
Maybe that's what
you
happened.
Do. That's true. Yeah, maybe. Maybe it's starting to rub off on you.
All right. Well, we've got our guests situated, I think. And on these mics, you do have to kind of get up real close. I'll just tell you that in advance. And then I'll go ahead and let let Steven do the introductions before I turn you on.
I don't know
hi
these
everybody.
People.
Oh, all right.
Oh, awesome.
So, hey, everybody. Say hello to our guests. Two people that Steven doesn't know.
Yes.
Hi, people.
We have Cody.
Hi.
And then we also have, do you want to do Kenny or Ken?
We'll do Ken.
Okay.
He's like, you know what? Let's go with Ken, Joe today.
He's like, Gimbab. Yeah.
So, well, welcome, guys. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you for having us.
Just get right up on the... Do you have them... Make sure they're turned on, too.
Yeah, they should be on.
Sure. Okay, good.
Yeah,
I'm just not,
you
I'm
can't,
not getting you real...
It's on, yeah.
Yeah, I can hear Cody.
Ding, ding, ding.
There we go. Just had to adjust you a little bit. Yeah. You weren't here for sound checks, so you know that's on you.
It happens.
Hey, whatever. It works.
Yes, we all work at the same place, but I invited Cody to come on to promote her GoFundMe page.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
So I figured get you guys on. I don't know if you tweeted it out or told people about it or anything like that, but we'll promote the hell out of it. But these two are gamers, so Eric,
solid.
You'll be out of the loop.
Sorry. I play Hearthstone on my phone.
You do.
So. That's all he's got.
And you're pretty good.
But
I'm
guess
getting better, so yeah, I appreciate
I guess
that.
Just pretty much why you want to go to school? Why did you start this thing? What's your fascination, I guess, with gaming? Let's just dive into it.
Well, let's see. I started gaming when I was really, really young. My older cousins used to play Diablo 2. Like, they played the shit out of Diablo 2, and I would watch them for hours. But when I was younger, I was too scared to play it by myself because I didn't want to die. But I started playing Pokemon and Nintendo and all that. My interest is the artwork. I want to draw and paint for the games because...
Like concept art?
Yeah.
Cool.
My goal is to be the art director.
Okay.
Eventually. but I'm trying to raise money because school is really expensive for it. And there are other ways, too, to like get into the whole gaming thing.
Yeah.
There's this website, it's Unity 3D, and it's really cool. It's like a community, and it has like forums and stuff, and you can download all the game design software.
Okay.
And it has step-by-step tutorial videos on how to code, how to program, and all that stuff. And so I'm going to try to dip my toes into that first.
What was the website again?
Unity 3D.
Okay.
It's pretty cool. Like other players can play your game and they can leave feedback and everything.
That's really, really cool.
Yeah.
That's it's like awesome.
The community aspect of it's really awesome.
Yeah, we went to Louisiana and his Uncle Joey's friend Troy, they were telling us about it because their school for game design is like $94,000. So it's pretty expensive.
I know of another way that you can get through all that, but it requires like virgin sacrifices and selling your soul and
well,
shit
you
like
know,
that.
I've been there before.
There's a lot of chanting involved, and
she's like, "That's how I became a lawyer and decided
like
not to do it."
You know,
if you get just one thing wrong, you're just totally fucked. So
yeah.
Everybody loves a good chant, though. Come on. Let's be real.
Well, I think it's like the whole game design thing. I've always had so many different interests. Like, I wish I had enough time in my life just to do everything.
Yeah.
Because I like learning about all types of things, like archaeology, wildlife biology, anything to do with animals at all. Anything science. Yeah. And then I'm really into like space and stuff. So one of my favorite games to play is Mass Effect. I've played through that game so many times. But
were you in favor of the original ending for the third one, or did you like?
At first, I was not happy.
Like half
of America.
Yeah, but honestly, I think after playing through it a couple times, I think it was definitely. Trying to drink your beer.
I seriously just fucking did that. I thought this was my beer, and I went to drink it.
You just tried to drink your microphone.
Man, I did.
We should be live streaming this.
Shit.
Aaron wanted you to know, man.
This beer's really dry. Fuck that.
It's kind of spongy.
I still have you beat. I drank a lamp once, so.
According to Aaron, Periscope has landscape mode now, too, so.
Oh, there you go.
So, just so you know.
Get it.
Anyways.
Yes.
Wow. I didn't know that was going to bring the conversation to a halt. I apologize.
Yeah. But yeah.
Damn you, Aaron, for bringing up information.
Once they did the remake or the redo of the
We Fucked Up.
We Fucked Up. Here we go. We apologize.
Yeah.
See, and I love BioWare because like, be I've always been a huge console. Fan of like the RPGs and stuff. So it's like,
I don't know. That'd be sick.
I'm in love with any. You can do anything in a game. I mean, there's been instances where game designers have created games for like, for instance, there's this game. It's called Remission, and it's like you're this guy and you're inside of a human body fighting cancer cells, and you have to pick up chemo pills to get like the reloads or whatever. And it was designed to help teenage kids that had cancer to like get them into the attitude of wanting to take the chemo.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Education type.
Yeah, exactly. And I mean, you can do so much. There's simulators for like combat and like simulators for, you know, jet flying and everything like that. And I mean, you can do anything. And so I figured if I got into game design, I could do every career I ever wanted, just put it in a game. And I think that's pretty awesome.
So, how long have you been drawing? Did you go to school for it? Is it just natural talent?
I've always drawn for as long as I can remember. I used to, when I was younger, me and my best friend Shelby, we used to draw Pokemon cards.
Okay.
We'd like make up our own Pokemon or whatever. And I don't know. We used to always draw. And my mom, she draws a lot too. She's really, really creative. And it's kind of, you know, me, my mom, and my two sisters all have like
inherited
something that we're good at when it comes to creative stuff. And drawing, it's just like, I don't know, it calms me down
for sure.
It's like heroin for me.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
No, it's one of those things like you lose yourself and find yourself at the same time. And I think that's awesome. Like,
yeah, that's rad.
And I mean, artwork wise, you know, getting a career doing something in artwork's really hard to like find because a lot of stuff you kind of have to work really, really, really hard. I mean, it's not, you know, Renaissance days where, you know, Picasso and Leonardo da Vinci and stuff's around. But I figured in games, gaming is such a huge industry and it's just growing because of all the technology. And I would love to, you know, draw something and then make it real. You know,
so do you create your own original ideas and draw them out, or do you like to sketch things and you know?
My big thing, I like to like look at pictures to kind of get an idea, and I always put my own little twist
on it. Yeah,
yeah. And I mean, I started drawing again recently. I stopped for a long time because of work and everything, and I was always tired. So. Yeah, life happened.
Yeah, for sure.
But, I mean, I love drawing, I love painting, I love anything that involves that. There was one point where I wanted to be a tattoo artist.
Okay.
And so I used to design tattoos for people and all that kind of thing. And I don't know, just anything with art and gaming, like, I game all the time anyway. So I figure, you know, designing them and getting to like try them out and that kind of thing would be really cool. So
yeah, definitely.
So I'm gonna make you and me feel really old right now.
Okay.
Because they're a lot younger than us.
Okay.
What were your guys' first gaming console?
My first gaming console.
Super Nintendo, I think.
Oh wow. Okay.
Awesome.
I actually had Sega. A long time, yeah.
I was expecting. I talked to kids that were like young one time. They're like, I was like, "What's your first system?" Like N64. I was like, "Oh God."
No, I love the N64. He actually bought me for Christmas. He got me the Pokemon edition with Pikachu on it.
Nice.
And his cheeks
light up.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's pretty cool.
Yeah,
that's
pretty fucking awesome.
Little accessories for it, but.
Dude, you can. Those things are worth so much money now, though. If you find the full set with all the games and the original controllers and everything, they go for like $600 a pop.
Yeah.
Easy.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Yeah. And I mean, Pokemon, I will always be a fan. I mean, it's like little animals and pets and stuff that have like superpowers. It's pretty awesome.
I
played the hell out of the Pokemon card game back in the day.
Oh, dude. I used to have so many Pokemon cards. It was ridiculous.
The last one I remember really playing was Silver. Silver, and that's where I stopped, I think. Silver.
Oh, for the Game Boy?
Oh, there you go.
Game Boy card.
I actually have an emulator on my phone.
Nice.
And I've got, my favorite is the Fire Red. It's okay. The updated version with Charizard, because Charizard is like the love of my life. Yeah. Sorry,
yeah,
babe.
Those emulators are awesome. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, I actually just dug out all my, when I was moving, I found all, I opened a box, I was like, the original Game Boy, and then all my Game Boy games. So I have like all the Pokemon stuff.
That's so cool.
And everything. But yeah, it was funny, because Matthew and I made a pack a while ago. We both had 3DSs. We're like, we should go get the new Pokemon. Oh, yeah. Came out, X and Y. Yeah, never followed
on that. No, we didn't do that. We should still do that.
See, I'm more into like old school Pokemon, just because, I mean,
there's so many now.
No, I,
oh my god,
I agree
I know.
I agree with that. I think I picked up one. I forget what it was, but it was for like the DS. I jumped in. I'm like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah, I felt like
hair and chandelier.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, this is not a. This is not an animal.
It's
this
turning into Digimon.
Yeah, this like, is just bits and pieces. Yeah. I'm pretty sure that's a dick.
I think that's like a home decor
dick
chair.
I choose you. Yeah.
I can sit on that chair.
You're like, bullshit. That's the bookcase from IKEA. Yeah.
Liar. You just put eyeballs on it. What are you doing?
Shit.
But yeah, no, I've always been super nerdy. I grew up with my boy cousins, and they were like 16 and 17 when I was like 9. So I used to play StarCraft and Vampire the Masquerade.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Yeah.
I haven't heard somebody say Vampire the Masquerade in a very long time.
I'm obsessed with the whole vampire idea. Yeah, I always have been for as long as I can remember. So I used to love watching them play that game. And then I used to, you know, Mario Kart, obviously, just because it's Mario Kart. And then we actually broke out the Super Nintendo not too long ago, and I was playing Super Mario World. Mm-hmm. And
she is crazy, ridiculously amazing at that game.
Yeah.
She gets all these extra little things, and I remember barely being able to get past like the first couple levels.
It's shit.
Well, and I'm a speed player in Mario. Like, okay. I run through the entire level. I like to the point where my thumb twitches whenever I'm done.
Yeah, shit.
Yeah. I know all the secrets to that game. I've lost hours of my life.
It's a great game.
It is.
I still remember coming home from school right when the Super Nintendo came out, and I didn't think I was going to get one, or I had to like wait until Christmas. Came from school and like did my homework. Mama was like, I think there's like a package or something up in your room. So I got up there, and she fucking set it up for me, and I had Super Mario World already in. All I had to do was hit the power button, turn on my TV, and could play. I was so pumped.
Really fast, just reminisce for a moment with me. Old school consoles and no updates.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes. Yeah.
Seriously?
Put it in.
And play.
And they didn't break.
Yeah.
I know, those things are freaking indestructible, man. Throw it off a 10-story building and be perfectly fine.
No glitches. Games are actually finished. No like updates coming. Like, oh, that level doesn't work right now, but in a week we'll have the new patch for it.
Yeah.
Dude, it's like when I get home, because I play RPGs. So when I get home off of work, you know, and I want to sit down and I want to play a video game, I turn my PlayStation on, and then I have to wait for an hour and a half. And by that time, I have to go to bed, because I have to be up so early to go to work. So it's like a... But, yeah.
No fun living in Queen Creek.
Yeah.
Time driving.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, it's far.
Damn.
But.
Well, thanks for coming out and making it.
Absolutely. Thanks for having us.
Yeah.
I appreciate it.
Yeah. Actually, yeah. Though, so you and Ken can talk about this. Kenny, he's been playing The Witcher 3.
Oh.
Yes.
So I don't know how far you're into it or how you are into it, but.
I'm on the Skellige Isles.
I'm just. Yes. Now they're wanting to send me that way, but yes. I'm like. And I know everybody I talk to, they're like, dude, Skellige is, like, fucking rad.
Yeah.
But I'm still like, but I have so much to do in, like, Novigrad. Like,
seriously, I probably, on the main storyline, I probably could have been done with that game weeks ago.
Yeah.
But all of the side quests are so fun, and they put so much detail into it. And then going to all the merchants and finding all the swords and all that stuff. I love that about games. The loot.
For sure.
Oh, yeah. And then how about that Gwent card game?
So I've played it a couple times.
Yeah.
It piqued Eric's interest.
Oh, yeah. I'm like, wait, there's a card game?
Dude. Actually.
Oh, dude, it's a game
Eric,
inside
really
of
like
a
it.
Game. Yeah, it's so awesome.
I like, these guys hate me, but I actually loved Final Fantasy VIII because of the card the card game stuff going on.
Well, you
like, I fucking love that.
I love how they do that. Yeah, like she said, put a game inside of a game.
It could be a game all itself. I mean, usually when you have games and, you know, like, for instance, the old school Star Wars games where you, like, run around. It's like Mass
Knights
Effect.
Knights of the Old Republic?
Yeah.
Yes, 1 and 2.
I mean, they've got, you know, some pretty good mini games on there or whatever, but this is, like... unbelievable how much detail they put into it. And I think it's really cool because they use
strategy
all the characters.
Too,
like, yeah,
right.
Dude.
Like, cards have power-ups and, like, Eric, you would love
field
it, man.
Bonuses.
You would love it,
for sure.
And a cool thing about it, too, is, you know, a big part of the actual game is going and collecting the cards and stuff. And that part gets really addicting. I'll, like, skip all this other stuff. I'll go into a town, and they're like, hey, help me. And I'm like, screw you.
I'm going to go play cards.
You go to hell. You go to hell, you die. There's a card over there.
You can fight that griffin, you know, whatever. Yeah. I'll be back in five. I got to go beat this guy.
Just play dead. Well, I'll be back in a minute.
And then the merchant tells
cards. That's what you do for a griffin attack, right?
Yeah,
that's like a bear.
That's a winning bear.
You play dead.
Oh, good. The witch is here. We have a griffin. Yeah, where's your card shop?
Dude, how about those botchlings, though? Those things are fucking creepy.
And they're fucking annoying. Yeah. Same with the drowners, man. Like,
dude, oh, yeah.
Come on.
Yeah, I know, right?
See, I haven't actually got a chance to play it yet because I got him the Xbox One for his birthday, and I got The Witcher with it.
We'll have to get your gamer tag.
And, absolutely. Yeah, for sure. But I'm not allowed to play it until he's done with it. And I'm like, all right, so I'll get to play it in 4 years.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Yeah. Like, babe, you might as well just wait to get the PS4.
Yeah.
I just finished The Bathhouse.
The Bathhouse? Okay, yeah. Yeah.
So I'm
not quite sure.
Now you piqued my interest again.
Dude, no. For real, though, there's some pretty M-rated scenes in that game.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
There's a lot of saucy puppet shows.
Yeah, that's right.
There's lots of boobies.
I banged an elven chick.
Oh, yeah, that bitch.
So what else did you do?
I know what you're talking about.
No. Not really.
And then that Yennefer bitch, she's hot, dude.
Dude, Yennefer, I'm not going after Triss at all. I'm going after Yennefer, man.
She is freaking gorgeous.
Yeah, she is.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to bang the shit out of her.
You know, right? I heard that if you play your cards right, that you might be able to get them both into bed.
Well, that's
just...
there might
be a little twist in it, so...
Huh.
Yeah, work for that. Play the field.
Well, shit. I'll do some research, but fuck, man. I already made my decision.
Just like in real life, I like a challenge.
Challenge accepted.
But
well, I already... That Kira girl?
Mm-hmm.
I already did that.
Yeah.
But I heard that like you can do that and it won't affect like the main girls.
Yeah, I
mean, the game's great. We're not just talking about like the hookup scenes, but
in this game.
Hey, hookup scenes are always nice.
Yeah, I mean,
fuck it.
I did the same thing. I did the same thing in Mass Effect 2.
Yeah, Mass Effect, yeah.
No, dude, okay, so I tried my very hardest because I'm always a female Shepherd just because the chick's badass, I think.
What the heck, dude? I don't know, I was just kidding.
Talking shit.
Yeah, sorry, dude.
But no, I tried so hard to get with Jack for the longest time.
Yeah.
And I realized you can't get with Jack. So I was very disappointed because I tried to play through with a guy, Shepherd, and it just didn't feel right. So I just said screw it. But I recently downloaded some of the DLC. I got From Ashes and The Citadel.
Okay.
And
I hear The Citadel is really good DLC.
Dude.
It is pretty cool.
Yeah, From Ashes, you get a Prothean on your squad, which is fucking cool. And then The Citadel, you actually get your own personal apartment. Anderson gives you his apartment, and it's bad fucking ass.
Yeah.
And you, like, throw this party and shit, and everybody's dancing, getting down.
No shit.
Yeah,
she puts more planning into her game apartment than she does our little place.
Yeah.
Like, dude, that's cool.
Well, shit, if I got the credits for it, you better fucking believe.
I'm about to decorate this
video game. You can put the couch in 15 different places to see what it looks like.
Yes.
You do that in real life, you're going to be fucking
tired.
Well,
that's what happens. You end up with all these credits, and then it's all like, I remember just buying like model ships for like my room in the.
And you can find them all over
the
Normandy,
Normandy
too.
You know, just finding stuff.
And all the fish and the aquarium feeders.
I totally got so angry when I forgot. I didn't know you had to keep feeding the fish.
And
so I bought the fish. I was like, yeah, I got fish. This is awesome, right? And then I leave for a couple of missions, come back. I'm like, where's my fish?
They're all
I don't know if it's in the first one or the second one, but in one of those, you get a space hamster,
which is
pretty cool.
I think the first one, because I think they added the fish in the second one.
We all know what he does with the hamster in that game.
What is he, Richard Gere?
gets lonely in space.
Too soon.
It's like, well, hamster, you and me on the ship on the Normandy alone.
Oh, shit.
We told that hamster he was going to go where the sun don't shine.
It's time for you to go.
He was scared until we sent him to space.
Yeah, he's nocturnal.
Yeah, I have yet to play through those games, Renegade, though. I have a really hard time making like the mean decisions for some reason. Once in a while, I'll pull the trigger just because they do pretty badass shit sometimes. I remember there's this one where you're like... you're investigating something and you're like talking to somebody and trying to get something out of them, and he's like not talking. He's like, yeah, pretty much fuck you. And you can pull Renegade. And if you do that, the chick, at least, I don't know if the guy does it, but the chick, she fucking like puts her elbow up to his neck and she's like, you better fucking talk, or,
yeah,
you know, I'll fucking do something. He's had like, to do with like kicking him in the balls or something.
I can't talk.
actually, my favorite Renegade one was with the female reporter, like in the third
and
one.
And you punch her in the face.
She starts giving you shit, and I thought I was just like she was talking shit about stuff. I'm like, I made some really good decisions. So I'm like, fuck you, and I hit the trigger.
The Jessica Chobot character?
No.
In the third one.
There's the chick that's in throughout all of them. She does all these bogus like news reports. So finally, in the third one, I hit the Renegade thing. I just punched her in the face. I'm like, I'm not even sad.
Because that's a Bond thing to do.
Yeah.
You see that one in Diamonds Are Forever. He like takes that chick bikini top off and then chokes her with it to get information. I mean, like, that's fucking awesome.
Well, you have to. Well, you have to do what you got to do. Especially when there's a Reaper invasion and some bitch is talking shit. It's like, you know what?
Yeah. I don't have time for you right now. Do you not see what's happening over here?
I have 50 fucking problems on my plate and you're not one of them, all right?
But seriously, don't trash my name.
Yeah.
But in all seriousness.
No, that game is so incredible. I love BioWare. I think BioWare does such an amazing job when it comes to storylines and stuff. And I think it's awesome, you know, Joker in that game, Seth Green.
Oh, I love that.
He's so funny. And he all hooks up with the robot, which I think is even better.
I feel like Seth Green would hook up with a robot if he could.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he probably would.
Like, I don't think that's made up. Like, I think
or
he's like
a freaking shark with freaking laser beams attached to his freaking head.
Throw me a freaking bone. What's up?
Austin Powers?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, Austin Powers.
My Rinky was a key.
Fuck yes.
But
sorry,
yeah.
Diamondbacks are up 8-0 right now.
Nice.
Oh, shit.
Over the Dodgers.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck it.
The Dodgers. Fuck them. Bullshit.
But yeah, no, gaming, man, the possibilities are endless. I actually just got I didn't just get it, but for some reason, like, I can handle haunted houses, scary movies, anything in that era, I absolutely love. But for some reason, when I play video games, it scares the holy fucking shit out of me.
Okay.
Anyways, I was watching the walkthroughs for The Evil Within before I bought it, and it looked like a badass fucking game. I literally have yet to play the game. I am so scared shitless because it's supposedly like one of the scariest games that they've made in a really long time. Which, you know, you start out and you go to this like insane asylum and everybody's dead, and then you get fucking knocked out or something and you wake up hanging from the ceiling by your ankles, and there's a big beefy dude chopping up body parts.
Yeah.
And you have to like sneak around everything, and it's pretty frightening.
So have you made it past that point?
She hasn't really started it.
Yeah. She tells me that
I have to play it with her, and so that whenever the scary parts happen, I'm the one getting killed.
She jump in front of the big burly guy chopping up body parts and go booga 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 and then run away. And he'll be so confused. He'll just be like,
why is this?
Like, I'm supposed to be this scary. Yeah. I'm chopping up a body.
Wait,
what the fuck is this bitch doing?
Well, there's this character. When I was watching the walkthrough.
She must be way too crazy for me to fuck with.
Yeah, we're going to go ahead and let you go.
There's a part, it's like the Spider Queen or something.
Oh, fuck that.
And anyways, you're walking down this hallway, and you know, it's like flickering lights with the white tile floor and shit, and you get to this room and the floor starts like melting upwards.
Okay.
And then comes out this fucking, she looks like the fucking Ring/Grudge/fucking spider with all these fucking arms and shit, and it's fucking scary. Like, if I
just
saw
guessing.
That, I would probably piss my pants.
So
not even going to lie.
You know the game because you've been watching it online.
Yes.
But you just won't play it.
I don't know.
Because you basically.
What it is.
You know what's going to happen.
All
I know.
About the game. She's like, oh, in this part. And then you turn the corner and then there's this guy.
Yeah.
She's like, I won't do it.
I know. I don't know. It's all in my head. It's just
I don't understand.
For some reason, like if I'm expecting something to happen.
Whoa. Just playing.
But yeah, no, I don't know. It's one of those, though. I mean, I've played through a lot of different games, but, you know, I used to play, like, Resident Evil and shit, and I remember there was this one time, old school Resident Evil. I don't even remember which one it was, but I was playing, I go through this room, and I used to have this really old, like, big screen TV, one of the monster freaking boulder.
Yeah.
And, like, I thought it was just a screen, but I saw, like, black, like, up at the top, and it was kind of flickering, and I was like, oh, you know, it's just a TV. And I walk into this room, and a giant spider drops down on my head.
Oh, yeah.
And I fucking was like, ah, fuck!
Yeah.
And my stepdad woke up, and he was like, what the fuck was that? It's pretty bad.
That was actually the remake they made of Resident Evil for the Wii. GameCube.
Yeah.
That one was funny, because that was the first time I ever played the first one.
Yeah.
So I never played it before. So my buddy, who already played it, we were like playing it, and he's like, okay, yeah, go here, you know, there's this kind of stuff. And then we get to this one spot, I'm like, what the fuck is that? He's like, I don't know, this wasn't in the original.
Oh, shit.
It was just like this thing with a bag over its head or whatnot. He's like, shoot it! Shoot her!
Shoot
her! Did the bag say, I am not famous anymore? Because I'm pretty sure that was just Shia LaBeouf.
Yeah, it was a shy surprise.
Oh, fucking shy surprise. I like that.
But wait,
I like
he isn't
that.
Dead. Yeah. Shy surprise. I fucking love that video.
But yeah, no, I always, that's actually me. Like, I started The Evil Within because I wanted something to play, but then all this other shit came out, so I'm like, all right, I'll come back to it. But yeah, it was like, just the opening, I was like, wow, there's no, oh, hey, here's a break. It was literally like, you fall from the ceiling, guy cuts you in the back of the leg, so now you're limping.
Trying to run for your
fucking everything.
Life.
I'm like, wow, this is, there's no like, oh, walk to this room. Oh, there's a ghost. Like,
you know,
it's like, fuck you.
Screwed around every corner.
Yeah. And as far as game design goes, I actually read that, the cockroaches that they have in it that are like crawling around.
Yeah.
I heard Resident Evil, like old school Resident Evil, like the game design was better for the cockroaches.
Oh, really?
Like, they were really low quality in The Evil Within because they focused on everything else.
Yeah, except for that.
Yeah, and I mean, shit, they did a damn good job because, damn.
Yeah, but yeah, because I actually want to pick up that new one that just came out called Until Dawn for the PlayStation 4.
That is something I would like to play, I think.
That was like The Last of Us and stuff like that. Like,
The Last of Us.
Fucking love that.
Yeah, The Last of Us was a beautiful fucking game. I loved that they made it like zombie-ish, but they made it like a real life.
Yeah.
It could happen. Like, because the fungus that takes over the body is actually a real thing. Mm. But it's only for, you know, insects and that type of thing. But they make it a different strain, so it affects humans. And I thought that was so badass. I love when games, like, take it and make it real.
The government did it.
Yeah, exactly.
I was just spouting bullshit conspiracy theories. I wasn't right, was I?
Still
never played the game.
Still to, like, I'm trying to think. It came out probably, I think, for the PS3.
They made it to kill the gays, and now it's loose.
His face.
I think the game came out 2 years ago on PlayStation 3, and then I just started playing the remastered version on PlayStation 4, and still just that opening.
That opening
is still like, wow, this is just like the start of a movie.
It's so sad.
And literally how they do everything, but you're just like, shit.
It really draws you into it, you know? It gets you emotionally involved, and you're like, oh my God, I gotta see what happens.
See, and that's what I love. Like, I actually, I have this game idea that I've kind of been playing with it. It just like came to me one day. But I've been playing the Tomb Raider. I got the ones, it's like Legend, Anniversary, and the other one. And I love Tomb Raider. It's, you know, great fucking game. And I love all the puzzles and stuff. Anyways, I came up with this idea of a game that I want to do. I want to call it The Legend of the Leviathan. And pretty much how I wanted to start out is you're an archaeologist trying to search for clues. Like, you're sailing the ocean to try to find clues for the lost city of Atlantis. And then a hurricane happens and you get stranded on this island that happens to be the island with the lost city of Atlantis on it.
What a coincidence.
Yeah, exactly. Well, the whole thing is,
I've been searching for this and now I'm stuck here.
The Leviathan is
Alanis
actually
Morissette, are you listening? That's irony. Not any of the shit you listed.
The Leviathan is actually the cause of the hurricane. What I want to try to do is try to figure out, you know, something with, you know, different types of astrology, like whenever the year of this is in play, the Leviathan draws in ships. And so there's like abandoned camps and stuff already on this island, and you go through and you see people's journals and like what they've written about the island, so you can learn about what's on the island. Mm-hmm. And the island's going to have mythological creatures all over it that you fight. And I also printed out a whole bunch of mythological just items and plants and that kind of thing. That I'm going to put in the game too, kind of like Easter eggs or whatever, because I love everything about like ancient Greece and mm-hmm. ancient Egypt and all that. But yeah, I want it to be kind of like an open world, like how Skyrim is, but I want it to be kind of Lara Crofty too, just, you know, the archaeologist portion. And
yeah,
I want it to be informational, like everything that you come across, like I'm going to have like a history about it and everything like that. It's kind of an idea that I'm mashing cool. together.
Yeah, but I think that's a great idea. It sounds fun.
Yeah, I love stuff like that. I love games where, like in Mass Effect, for instance, when you're, you know, scouting the planets, it gives you the full history mm-hmm. about the planet, everything about it, and, you know, a lot of the planets that they have in it are actual planets that, you know, scientists have seen, you know, and I think that's awesome. I love stuff that you learn from. I love learning new things. Yeah. So I'm kind of a nerd that way.
No, that's great. Learning's rad. Education, man.
Yeah. Right.
Well, we're getting ready to cut to break for a few minutes here. Okay. So yes. Well, before we do that, tell people where they can go to find your GoFundMe page to help out
your dream.
Pushing this dream through.
All right. Well, my Twitter account has it all over it. My Twitter account is actually, it's GURLZ, so girls, and then game 2, just the number 2. And then the GoFundMe is GoFundMe.com, and then the / and it's /against_all_and_odds.
We'll also have the link on the page when we put up this episode. So
sweet.
It'll be on the... Yeah.
All right, sounds good.
ForRideRadio.com and SociallyAwkwardStudios.com, as well as on our Facebook pages, Facebook.com/
yeah, ForRideRadio Network. Anything helps.
Yeah,
and
we'll pimp it out.
Yeah, and, you know, $94,000 is a lot to try to raise money for. And
what
honestly,
school is it?
Honestly, the ones that I've looked at, because I was going to look into the art institutes, but I was looking up schools for, you know, game design, and one of the top 10... that I came across was actually in Tempe. It's called the University of Advancing Computer Technology.
Is it off Baseline?
I don't know. I know it's in Tempe.
Yeah. Start naming more streets, Matt.
Isn't
no,
that
there's one right. There's one right next to
UAT. You're talking about
UAT. Is it UAT?
UAT, yeah, UAT? University of Anten. I don't think it's got an extra letter in there, though. But that's Paul, who was on the show
yeah.
previously.
Yeah,
he
that's
taught
right.
there.
Oh. Yeah.
So, yeah, we've got ties. We've got
yeah.
ties in there.
No,
we got a little
We know a guy
a
who used to at one point teach there and now is living in L.A. doing something else altogether. But, you know.
Oh, is that what
yeah,
you said?
And I watched.
I think so. I think he's back. He was in L.A. for a while and he's back.
He's back.
Right. Yeah.
I've been watching a lot of... conferences, gamer conferences and stuff, and honestly, you don't need a degree to do game design. You just need a kick-ass portfolio, so yeah. you just need to know what you're doing. My whole thing is, though, is I want to go to school for it because there's so many other things that are mixed up into gaming. Like, for instance, if I want to do anything that has to do with history, I'd like to take, you know, history class on, you know, whatever it is, or... And the conferences, they talk about all the time how gaming is half technology, half psychology, because you want the player to feel like they're part of the game. You want them to, you know, feel rewarded if they do something, or like wondering what's behind this door type thing. You want to keep them guessing. You want to keep them coming back. And psychology is actually one of the courses that you take at that school. But like I said, $94,000, that's a lot of money, and I don't expect to get anywhere near that. But anything helps.
For sure.
I you
Sorry.
Know.
We're up 10 to nothing at the bottom of the second, so
oh,
I'm a little bit
right
happy
on.
About that.
You got money?
Eric with baseball news. Update.
But yeah, I really appreciate you guys for having us out. It's really
Absolutely.
Cool.
Thank
I feel all
so
fancy talking on a microphone and stuff. Can't lie.
Hell yeah.
Oh, we're yeah. glad to have you on, glad to promote, and hopefully help push you towards that goal. And if we find that we are able to do that, then we need to, you know, put our own you know, money-making schemes to work and try to figure out how to make this profitable for us, too. One of these days. One of these days.
Shit, let me know, man. I can pass you betas of different types of games and shit when
hell
they come
yeah.
out.
If you make a card game, you let me know.
Oh, dude.
Or
I'm all about it.
Also do puzzle games and things like that,
oh,
too.
Oh, dude, yeah, yeah, yeah.
See, if you get into that, I'll help beta test the fuck out of those.
Yeah. Like, do you guys remember that old school game? It was for PlayStation 1. Steve and I have actually talked about it. It's Myst.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
PC, too. I played it on PC.
Yeah, it was on PC, yeah.
I have that actually downloaded on my PlayStation 3. But I used to play games like that, and there's Time Lapse, and there's another one. I think it's called...
Play the 13th Guest.
13th Guest. I haven't heard of that one.
It was a horror game.
Oh.
Really, like, really cheap.
Yeah.
But, yeah. I mean, obviously, for the time when it came out, like...
It was, like, the shit.
I think it was the 13th Guest. Yeah, it was in, like, a haunted house, and there was, like, a dinner party, and, like, people get, like, knocked off.
One by one, kind of like Clue.
Yeah, and you got to figure out who done it. Yeah. So it was, it was a fun game.
Yeah, Time Lapse is really cool. It's like, I don't remember all of it, but my mom really liked to play it too, and I used to watch her play it. And there was another one. I think it's called like Amber, and you're in this house and you're trying to figure out like who killed who or whatever. And I love stuff like that because it makes you think. I actually recently just we went to GameStop. And I bought a game for like $5. It was the Sherlock Holmes game. And I thought it was going to be cheesy, you know, because I hadn't really heard anything about it.
What was it based on?
The Seventh.
Was it from one of the movies? Or was it
from... You're like, Sherlock, and you get to play as Watson as well. And
I don't think it was based on any of the movies. I think it's more of a standalone type of...
Okay.
It's the seventh game, I think, in the series. I guess they have seven of them. But I thought it was going to be like a little kid game, but I'm okay with that. I totally... You know, Kung Fu Panda was my shit. Okay. But I started playing this game, and this priest gets murdered. And you straight see his body.
As one does. So.
And his fingers are like broken backwards. And he's on like acid all over his skin. And he's burned alive. And I was like, wow, it's definitely not a little kid game. But you go through and the puzzles in it are actually really, really difficult.
What happened to Father Charlie? What happened to the priest?
Same thing that will happen to you if you don't do your homework.
Oh, damn, that was dark.
Well, you see, that priest was one of those bad priests we talked about.
Remember Jared?
Oh, too soon.
He was my buddy.
Dude, danger. I worked at Subway for 4 years. Hearing about that shit, I was like, Jesus.
Oh,
geez,
that's funny.
But yeah.
Everyone looks at footlongs now completely differently.
It was the seventh guest, not the 13th guest, so. Oh, that was, dude, yeah. Leave it at that. If that happened, I was going to be like, of course it was fucking Eric.
You little bitch.
All right, let's cut to break for a little bit.
Yeah, let's take a break. And when we come back, hey, you guys down to play some Cards Against Humanity on the air?
Yeah, sure. Let's do it. Right. I've never played before. You're going to have to teach me.
Oh, it's awesome. It's really easy.
I hear good things.
It's really easy. Cool. It's really easy. All right, so we're going to go ahead and cut to break, and we will be back in a few minutes for y'all.
Cool.
First list of fiction my mouth has made first. Eliminate the distance between us. I've got to implicate first. List of life my mind has made first. Eliminate the distance between us. Truth be told, you're hard to hold. You gotta want it, you gotta want it right now. Truth be told, the damage that caused me pain first. Eliminate the distance between us.
feel the difference. That a little distance in between us starts to show. I can tell you what you want if you really wanna know. I can take you to the top if you really wanna go. If you just say yes, if you stop saying no. If you just a test that you want me so. I can feel the difference. That a little distance in between us starts to show. Tell you what you want if you really wanna know. I can take you to the top if you really wanna go. If you just say yes, if you stop saying no. If you just a test that you want me so. Me.
tell me your problems. I'm here for you. Just try to stay sober. It's eating you. And they say you are a monster. What I see is a child. Your eyes are glowing red. And your tongue has caught on fire.
And we are back. Thanks, everybody, for hanging out with us during the break. Appreciate that. Thank you, Matthew, for the tunage during the break.
Absolutely.
All right. It's finally time. We haven't had a chance to play Cards Against Humanity on the air for a while.
It's time for what?
We haven't had guests on or guests that were willing to play or whatever.
It's
we
time
have actually
for what?
Cards Against Humanity. I just said that.
Oh. We've been playing that other one that Matthew brought over.
Oh, yeah, we did play that once because we only had the three of us, so this wouldn't
work.
Yeah,
we played it a couple times. It was good.
Yeah, you weren't there for the other times.
Yeah.
I know.
The other one time.
Because I wasn't invited.
The Matthew, the other times. I'm trying to make Eric feel
better.
I know.
You were camping? Or?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
That's what he calls it.
I was taking the week off because I just couldn't stand the sight of you fuckers.
No, actually, technically,
Eric. Oh, isn't that just nice?
I'm sorry, Matt.
Technically, Eric is Heisenberg.
Hey, man.
I actually stalked your Facebook pages the entire weekend because I missed you guys so much.
Aww.
Oh, please tell me that's not true.
Tear.
Please tell me you didn't do
which
that.
Which way do you want it?
I don't want it that way.
Dark or mushy?
Another thing you never want to hear in the bedroom. Which
way
do you want it?
Oh.
Matt posted a new update.
Yes. Yes.
Like.
Well, we can leave you alone for a couple minutes if you need it.
I'm good.
Why does he keep on unliking? Yeah, liking, unliking.
Yeah, I don't understand what's going on.
Eric, what are you doing? I gotta send him a gift.
Eric's wife just walks in and be like, "You're doing it again, aren't you?"
No!
Why are your pants off? Doesn't matter.
Well,
it doesn't matter.
They weren't comfortable.
We do get in the little gift.
We do, yeah.
GIF stories.
The most amazing thing is the discovery that we can converse completely in GIF form via the Facebook Messenger app, which is just absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, it's fucking rad.
It's so much fun.
I'm sure. All right.
No, yeah, we've been doing that now.
So what we like to do, we've done this before when we've had guests on the show, for the second half of the show, play a little game of Cards Against Humanity for those who don't know the game. It's basically like apples to apples for horrible people.
Yes,
we are horrible people, so that's what we do basically. The black cards are the question cards.
Oh, shit.
All right.
We take turns going around the circle, asking the question cards, and everybody else has to answer it with their white answer cards.
Okay.
And the person who is reading the black card on that turn judges the answers and determines which one they like the best, whether it's the funniest, whether it fits the best, whatever criteria they want. It's their choice.
All right.
And then that whoever's put that answer in gets the awesome point for that turn, so they get the black card to hang on to say I win.
Nice.
We don't have any prizes for the winner or anything. Maybe a hearty congratulations. We'll let you have one of the beers you brought.
Oh shit.
If you win.
Oh, thank you.
If you win.
Thank you, by the way.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Yes.
We weren't going to come empty-handed.
Party
we don't believe in that.
Oh, well, that's good.
I've been really excited to play because since the last time we've played,
Eric
has
I've added 4-5 expansions since the last time we played.
I know, dude. These towers are getting pretty aggressive.
So this deck currently consists of the base deck.
Yes.
All 6 official expansions.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
All 5 crabs adjust humidity expansions.
I'm not going to count again.
The Cox abreast humility expansion.
The what?
Cox abreast humility.
Yeah. That's dirty.
We also have the cards
goodness.
And punishment expansion.
Okay.
We have the official packs of the 90s, the Science Pack, and the Holiday 2015 pack are in here.
You got those?
Just those 3. I haven't gotten the Holiday 2014.
How'd you get those?
From their website. I just ordered
them. Oh, I thought they were like limited.
No. Those are like the packs and the packs Prime. Like those ones I don't have.
Oh.
But the ones, the Science, the 90s, the Holidays.
Dude, I'm excited. Let's play. Come on.
All right. Well.
And then we also have, just so you guys know, there is a Faces of Destiny one in there. Well, those ones are just pictures that are answers. Mm. So we've kind of made the basic rules of the game is that everybody gets 10 white cards. Since we have
so many, be white?
And we want you to have a good base to choose from to make a good, funny answer, we're going to let you draw 12 cards. So all everybody right. can draw 12 white that cards so from special. The various stacks right now. Everybody just grab 12 white cards.
All right.
Just 12 of them.
Let's do this.
And then while there's silence, I'll just go ahead and put a little bit of music in the background. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Thanks, man.
Absolutely.
Appreciate that. Don't want it too much, though. Now, I don't know if we want to institute anything where if you have too many... Because, okay, so here's the thing. If you ever are looking at your hand and you're like, oh, crap, I have nothing I like whatsoever.
Dude, 12's kind of... intense. I'm not going to lie. This is a lot of cards.
All right, so I can...
And I'm also trying to hold my microphone, so bear with
me.
Oh,
yeah, I forgot you guys are
holding
the
mic. Ooh,
I like
this card.
All right.
Oh, so, my God, some of these are...
Well, we might just have to make a GoFundMe page just for mic stands.
There you go. So,
what if I get a picture of someone?
That you can use that as an answer, and we will describe the pictures if it fits.
We haven't seen those yet.
Yeah, to be fair, that's a brand new thing. We haven't done that yet, so we're
working that in. This is the first time we've played with that one, so we'll see how that works. If it doesn't,
let's just say we're popping a lot of cherries tonight.
Oh, wow.
Which one? That one.
You have to change
a bit. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So also, I was thinking, because there are a lot of picture cards in comparison to the total percentage, if at any point in your hand you've got more than three of the Faces of Destiny cards, you can feel free to turn in the extra ones for other white cards if you want to. There is also a rule in the game called rebooting the universe. If you ever look at your entire hand and say, I got absolutely jack shit.
All 12
of them? You can. Well, so that's why we did this, so we don't have to worry about that so much.
Dude, 12 is so intense.
Should we do 11? Would that make you feel better?
No, we're fine.
But this one goes to 11. No. this one goes to 12. We're even better than that.
I can't even read all of them.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm going to bitch the whole time.
Okay.
All right. So I have four of those Faces of Destiny cards.
So if you feel that's too many, go ahead and... What do you think? Three is enough?
Yeah, that's fine.
So go ahead and turn one of those in. Just throw it in the discard pile, which is this box right here, and grab a different white card instead. If you feel that that's just too dang many pictures, because we, like I said, this is the first time we've done this with the pictures. We'll see how that works out.
All right.
Who's gonna go first? Eric,
I'll go first. I'm right here.
Yeah,
right
here. Eric, kick it off.
All right. So here we go. Very first one. This is the question you want to fill in the blank for. In Rome, there are whisperings that the Vatican has a secret room devoted to blank.
I have some pretty good ones for
this. A secret room in Rome devoted specifically to this. I really wish I could play this because I have the perfect card.
Don't look at my shit.
I'm not looking at it. What? It's not like poker.
All right. So what do I do when I choose my card?
You hand it to me because I'm the card czar this turn, meaning that I'm
and
the
one
who's
taking
the card.
When you turn in a card, remember to grab another card too. It's 12.
Oh, yeah, that's right. All right. Yeah, you always want to have 12 in your hand at all times. So once you play a card, pull a card.
All right. Let's try this one.
All right. All right, I got all the answers here. Let's make sense.
Dude, I don't know if I'm going to take another one. This 12's intense. I think I'm just going to coast.
You want to put yourself in a disadvantage? You go right ahead. All right.
I'm just going to cruise.
Come on,
Matthew.
Be like everybody else. Cool.
In Rome, there are whisperings that the Vatican has a secret room devoted to concealing a boner. That's a little topical right there. Rome has a secret room devoted to 10 incredible facts about the anus.
Oh. Well, damn.
Just 10?
Not 12?
I don't know.
Seems a little seems a little light to me. I don't know. Or does the Vatican have a secret room devoted to jerking off to Coldplay?
What the fuck? Oh, nice, man. Dude, come on.
And she was yellow.
Yeah, buddy. Yeah, for sure. Dude.
I can't even.
Chris Martin, man. Come on.
I couldn't.
He laced it out.
I couldn't get it up to the band or their songs. I don't understand.
Eric, you can't get it up in jail.
Hey. We love you.
Wow, all right.
All right.
Or do they have a secret room devoted to teaching a robot to love?
That's sweet.
Hopefully not the same room as the jerking off to Coldplay, because that could
be real
awkward.
That is what they're teaching the robot how to do. love thyself.
Because it reminds me of conversations already had in this game, I've got to go with concealing a boner. Who here is concealing a boner? He's concealing a boner. He wins the awesome point.
So you get one.
So just hang on to that.
Yeah,
that is your awesome point.
So,
All right. So go around the horn. Go ahead and grab a black card from either stack and read the question.
All right. Give me just a second.
Sorry. I tried to spread them out as much as possible.
This works a lot better when we're just at the table. But.
Yeah.
No, it's totally fine. All right. So the question is, what has been making life difficult at the nudist colony?
Let's see. What is making life difficult at the nudist colony?
Yes. Oh, the kitty. Do you hear the
kitty?
Oh,
my God. I've got so many great ones for this.
All
this
right.
Sucks.
There you go.
Oh, jeez.
Let's try this. Thank you.
Oh, boy. This is going to be interesting, huh?
Hopefully. Usually I laugh at them and then no one finds them funny, so it's just me.
Do I go mildly humorous or do I go dark and disturbing is the question.
Deep. Go deep.
Dark and disturbing it is.
All right.
All right.
All right, so what? I shuffle them?
Yeah, just mix them up. Just so, you know, it doesn't really matter.
All right.
Unless you were like really intently paying attention to which person handed which card.
All right, so what has been making life difficult at the nudist colony? And we've got some answers. The first one, buying the right pants to be cool.
That's going to cause a ruckus.
Be like, what? Why are you wearing pants at all? What the hell, man?
John, you had one rule.
They told me these shorts were in style.
This is why we can't have nice things.
I just like
the feel of the fabric.
All right. And apparently, the Yellow Dick Road makes things difficult at the
Yellow
nudist.
Dick Road?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. That's a new one.
Oh, all went wrong. You don't like my road?
Rough to see the wizard.
All right, the next
emphasize
one.
Emphasize on wizard.
Wizard, yeah.
Apparently, kids with ass cancer is also making things difficult at the nudist colony.
Just right there. Right there in your face all the time.
I'm trying to get with this MILF here, and her kid with ass cancer is just getting in the way of everything.
Everywhere I look, ass cancer.
And the last one is Nutella is making life difficult at the nudist colony.
Nutella makes everything better. How could it make anything difficult?
Sometimes you just got to get down on Nutella.
All right.
Even at the nudist colony. I mean,
I totally have to choose the kids with ass cancer because I thought
I knew
hilarious.
Dark and disturbing was the way to go.
Fuck! I was being too literal.
I thought that
I'll
was
take
hilarious.
That, and then you can put those in the box here.
Somebody, all right. Somebody really, buying pants. Come on. That's about to cause an uproar.
I really thought the Yellow Dick Road had it.
No, that was pretty funny. That was close.
Alrighty, folks. We have our next question or statement. Next time on Dr. Phil, how to talk to your child about Glenn.
Oh, I got the perfect one. I like the tunage in the background.
Here we go.
So
you ready?
Like party.
Hey.
What?
Got some brew. Got some Cards Against Humanity.
Shit, what do I want to...
You want to play a card?
No. I wonder what I'm down to now. I think I'm at 8.
How many cards have you played in 2 turns? Let's think about this for a second.
Yeah.
Fuck off! I'm at 9.
Matthew really hates these 12 cards.
Alrighty, shit.
But you know what he hates worse than 12 cards?
What?
Is chronic tardiness.
Oh, shut the fuck up. Don't even get me started.
Not too late.
Okay, so next time on Dr. Phil.
Fuck yeah.
How to talk to your child about anal fissures like you wouldn't believe.
I'm down with this enthusiasm.
Wow. That's okay. Right up there with the ass cancer. Right there.
That's probably how they got it.
Yeah.
Shit.
And we also have next time on Dr. Phil. How to talk to your child about quiche.
It's basically an omelet in pie form. I don't know how else to describe it.
What is it? What is it?
It's a fucking,
what is
it's
it?
It's an egg pie.
You
I
have a problem.
Oh, shit. Call it a fancy name if you want. It's fucking eggs, man.
I love quiche.
All right. Next time on Dr. Phil, how to talk to your child about overpowering your father.
What you need to do is get yourself a gun. And just put it right on your belt. He's not gonna fuck with shit.
Alright, so our last one is next time on Dr. Phil, how to talk to your child about beef curtains.
Yeah. I'm down with the beef curtains for sure.
Alright.
Well, if you date fat women like me.
Dr.
Phil, we don't need them.
Our winner is going to be next time on Dr. Phil, how to talk to your child about overpowering your father.
No!
Damn.
No, that's the last thing we want.
It never happens.
Yeah, that's actually another thing that happens is we never try to let Eric win.
Oh, no.
We were doing really good for a while.
We were.
You remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
I do. All right.
It's a new team. Team fucker.
All right.
Yeah, right?
Okay. To prepare for his upcoming role, Daniel Day-Lewis immersed himself in the world of blank. can't do a Daniel Day-Lewis, so.
All right, this one's probably kind of dark, but whatever.
You pass that down for me. Thank you, sir.
I'm like rocking out to this music right now.
Also, an unwritten rule, which isn't really a rule,
this
but
is
just
Chromio.
Trust me, you'll hate yourself if you do this. When you do draw a new card after having turned in your answer, never look at it right away.
Because
it will always be better than the answer that you just turned in for that question.
Yeah, I just found
every
that out.
We were trying to make that a drinking game. If you look at your card and go, damn it! You have to take a drink.
Ooh, interesting.
Well, I guess I'll take a drink then.
The cards and punishment cards are a little bit larger than the cards.
I'm not happy about that.
Everyone turn in their stuff.
I'm less happy about that than about the 12 cards.
But the crabs against are the same size,
exactly,
right?
Yeah. Huh, and so are all of the others. It's only those cards and punishment ones.
Huh. This is going to be fun to try to do.
Yeah, that's annoying.
Okay, to prepare for his upcoming role, Daniel Day-Lewis immersed himself in the world of the smooth...
It's good.
The smooth... unblemished skin of a child.
Oh, shit.
At least it's not a one with ass cancer.
He's got it.
There's probably going to be one in
there. Dude, maybe he's playing Jared from Subway or something.
Oh. Yeah,
no, I think this is his role for Subway. A micro penis.
Sorry.
Just
no
a little fella. Just a little fella.
I always fuck this stuff up. I know the word. I can't say it. Vehicular, I totally fucked it up. Manslaughter.
Vehicular?
There we
vehicular?
Go.
Okay.
I'm like ventricular.
Something to do with the heart?
I'm like, I know the word, but my mouth does vehicular not want to say it.
Oh, that's another fun game to play. Anytime Steven's reading the question, find the wordiest card you've got.
Right.
Yeah,
the dyslexia kicks in, and all of a sudden he's like,
fuck.
Fuck with the kid with dyslexia. I hope you get cancer. I hope you get dick cancer.
Ass cancer, to be specific.
Sitting alone.
I thought that bracelet was what would Jesus do for a second.
Oh, yeah, because I'm a big Jesus.
I was like, yeah, no.
I was just telling Matthew how today at work I found the Book of Mormon soundtrack was on Spotify. So I was just dying laughing at that. But sitting alone in the dark listening to Drake.
Ooh.
I'm going to have to go with the smooth, unblemished skin of a child.
Yes! For the win.
Nice.
Nice. Woo!
All right.
All right, Matt, you're up.
I am up. Oh, this is a twofer.
Oh, twofer. Okay, so on twofers, here's that way we do it. When you turn them in, the one you want read first, you want face down first. Okay. So the second one on top. So that way when the person reading them flips them up, they see the one they want to read first, and then behind that... is the one you want them to read second. All right,
so this one would be first.
I know, right?
Yeah, so then when they get it, they flip it.
That buzzes.
Okay. Oh, no, I'm listening to the track.
It's not common.
It's common track.
Oh.
Sorry.
Sounds like just a guy playing a bass.
Yeah, stand-up bass. No keys.
All right. So what's the question? Track.
All right. The tears of my blank shall make me blank.
The tears of my blank shall make me blank.
The tears of my blank shall make me blank.
Yes.
Yes.
Not gonna lie, I'm having difficulty with this one.
The twos.
Sometimes the twofers are harder, and sometimes they're so much easier.
This is gonna be
every now and then. They go up to three. There's actually some that are pick three.
The worst one ever is when people like put their cards down. They're like, these are just throwaway cards, and they win.
Oh, that makes me mad.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
I don't care if you want to do throwaway cards. That's fine. Don't say that.
So this is the first and the second.
Oh, and this is a handwritten question card, too. That's fine.
Yeah.
Does it say...
No.
This was before we remembered to ask people to sign their blank cards.
No,
so
I told
know.
Them not to sign their cards to piss you off.
Oh, okay. Fair enough.
Any little inconvenience I could put in your life makes me happy.
I knew it.
Damn it.
Do you see what you've done?
Hey, at least I didn't sell you a car with a hornet's nest.
Oh. Thankfully, neither did the people who sold me a car this week.
Okay, so the first one that we do is facing down?
Down, yes.
No, both of them face down, but the one you want red first on the bottom.
Okay.
That way when
so
they
that
look
way,
at it.
Yeah.
All right. Sweet.
All right, so what do we got here?
You want to make the first card your power bottom.
I gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah, I gotcha.
Like Steven.
Yep.
Glad you think so. You weren't saying that last night.
Sometimes I like a change of pace, okay?
No, you don't. It's been an entire week of you just like, harder, harder. And then,
it's been
this
a rough
guy.
Week, okay?
Get this guy. I'm fucking him in the ass, right? I reach around to see what he's got. He's got a fucking boner. What a faggot.
Okay.
I had a lot to drink.
Whoa, damn. Following up that comment.
there were pudding pops involved.
Here we go.
You see it?
The tears of my natural male enhancement shall make me nurses?
I think those are surgeons.
Surgeons?
It's a picture.
Yeah, like what the fuck
What's
do I do
like?
With this?
I'm gonna make you operate.
Well, you give your interpretation of the picture, I suppose.
I said nurses.
But I guess you
thought
it was
like,
nurses.
It looks like surgeons.
Yeah.
I really would have gone with surgeons, but evidently Matt saw...
You could just
nurses.
Say Greg's anatomy.
Not that was my entry or anything. I have no idea what Matt's looking at right now.
Dude, that one's not fucking winning. That's
wow.
Damn.
Hey, you don't know how bad the rest of these are yet.
Yeah.
Fuck, man.
That could be the best one.
The
because,
tears.
Okay, so but it makes sense
Dude,
if you think about it.
Let
natural
it go.
Male
let
enhancement
it go.
Didn't work, so now I have to have surgery because the tears of my natural male enhancement didn't work. So
Eric,
now
too literal, man.
I'm getting the cock job.
Eric, what we just said.
All right, shit. Here we go. The tears of my raptor attacks.
Okay.
I like all that. Right. Make me Magneto's other purple helmet.
Oh! Now, see, that would have gone with a natural male enhancement.
That one's funny. What is Cox? Okay.
Raptor attack is always good.
Jurassic Park. Jurassic World. You guys see Jurassic World?
Not yet. I want to so bad.
Oh my gosh, you guys.
I want to so bad.
The tears.
Go, leave right now. Go see it.
The tears of my sad hand job shall make me falling into the toilet. Shall make me fall into the toilet.
I love that. I love Matthew's.
I love when there's the, I love when there's the two first and like the first one you're like, oh yeah, okay, all right.
All right, the tears of my crushing your enemies, seeing them driven before you and wearing the laminate.
Lamented.
What the fuck? What is it?
Lamented? Perhaps?
Is that it? Lamentations?
Lamentations.
Of their women?
Oh, yeah, that's from Conan.
And this dude getting blasted in the face? Shall make me get blasted in the face?
Sure, why not?
Sorry, guys.
I have a feeling raptor attacks winning.
This is what you have to do.
No, we're going to do sad hand job.
Oh,
yeah, two
oh,
first. Man.
Oh, what?
Yeah. You know, I think I thought I would have won with Matthew's affection with raptors.
I didn't think I was going to win that one.
I was voting for your raptors.
Dude, the two first kind of bum me out sometimes.
Everything bums you out.
All right.
You're like, 12 cards, too many, bums me out. Two first bum me out. You people in this room bum me out.
I'm sorry. I've been kind of negative this week. I have.
Hey guys, that's a first, actually,
I apologize.
All right, it's time for some serious talk.
All right,
serious talk, guys.
All right.
What is this town's best kept secret?
Oh.
What is this town's best kept secret, guys?
Here you go.
Wow. Well, this one might be actually a little close to home. Let's see if Eric's smart enough to put two and two together.
Five!
Oh,
damn it!
Wait, damn it.
All right, here we go. Round and round we go. Where they land, nobody knows. Okay. What's this town's best kept secret?
I don't know. You're going to tell me.
Oh, I just...
Explosions!
Meth labs.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this one's just sad. What's this town's best kept secret? No longer finding any Cards Against Humanity cards funny.
Oh, that's only in Salt Lake City.
An emperor penguin with no sense of shame. I love penguins, but what?
I didn't even know ones were out here.
I want to know this secret. What's this town's best kept secret? Fuck Mountain. Who knows where Fuck Mountain is?
No one does.
Who knows where Fuck Mountain is? All right. You're going to have
no,
to tell me.
Mine.
Oh, I thought it was...
Mine was Fuck Mountain.
Oh, man. You got to acknowledge. You just won motherfucker.
Sorry, man.
With Fuck Mountain.
Fuck Mountain.
So where's Fuck Mountain?
I know, right?
Hey, it's the best.
It's a secret.
Best you kept motherfucker. Secret.
Secret.
I take your awesome point back and give it to Explosion.
Damn it. I keep coming in like second. I feel like the fucking Olympics where it's all like, you win gold, you feel great.
Who's
you
up?
Win bronze, you at least got something. You win silver, it's like, congratulations, you've almost won.
You almost won. Oh, yeah, it's your turn.
All right, guys. What's my anti-drug?
Cody's anti-drug, huh? Let's find out.
Okay, this one might actually be true.
I apologize for this in advance.
No, it's not actually anything bad, but it's like, I'm like, I don't know if I should go with truth or bullshit.
The one rule is you never want to hit the nail right on the head, because then everybody's like, oh, too exact. Like, you get that perfect card that's like the perfect answer to the question, and then it never wins because everybody's like, ah, no, it's too literal.
Too close to home. Man.
Yeah.
All right. Let's find out what my anti-drug is, shall we?
What is your anti-drug?
Sunny D. All right.
It's got solar energy.
Vitamin C.
Hell yeah.
Which technically, wouldn't that be vitamin D if it was actually solar energy?
Yeah.
Motherfuckers.
Hi, I'm Eric. I
fucking
like
commercials. Added to us. Lying to us.
All right. My anti-drug is a jar of bees.
Not the bees!
Oh, my God.
The bees!
I would say,
not the bees!
I am allergic to bees. So I'm just going to throw that out there.
Yeah,
so
me too.
That would
totally.
Be really bad.
Yeah,
I'm totally allergic to bees.
I'm allergic to bees, too.
Not so much the bees I'm allergic to. It's the pain of the sting that I really don't want to have. So.
All right. What is my anti-drug? Slightly more than 3 ounces of cum. Jesus.
I don't think Jesus came.
Not yet.
Slightly under 3 ounces.
Nah.
My anti-drug. My collection of high-tech sex toys.
Whoa.
Well.
I think that's, that'll get that's you to that slightly best kept secret.
That'll get you there to that slightly less than 3 ounces of cum.
I think I might have to go with the high-tech sex toys just because it's pretty funny.
Yay. See, right. I like these guests. We should have them back.
We're cool people.
Yeah, Eric, because apparently all the guests I've invited before have been crap.
No, it's not so much that they're crap.
Eric's like, now that you mention it.
It's just that they don't let me win as much at this game.
Well, they don't know you yet.
We're on team going.
Yeah!
Which is funny because I'm going to show up on work on Monday and be like, oh, fuck Eric, really. I hate that guy. Did we put on a good performance?
Motherfucker. You guys are my only friends.
It's your turn.
All right. We have, it says, Cards Against Humanity. Oh, wait.
But how many can we answer?
So, what's fun until it gets weird?
Damn it!
Doesn't that suck?
This one would work so well!
Don't do it! Oh, man.
Dude, I got some discards I need to get rid of for sure.
You know, maybe if you had 12.
All right. I'm going to take a chance. Taking a chance.
What?
Oh, man.
Just playing.
Can you grab that? I'm sorry. Hopefully it didn't land face up. Cause
no, it didn't.
All right, that's good news.
I'm gonna throw my shit away and get new ones.
Well, no, reboot the great. Universe?
Rebooting the universe. All right.
Yeah.
Don't forget to grab 12. It's 1, 2, an even dozen, Matt.
All right, guys.
No matter how much it upsets you.
That's 6 and 6.
What is fun?
5 plus 7. 4 plus 8.
Until it gets weird.
Done some math in this, bitch.
I did 9.
What's cool? What's good until it gets weird?
So these fun things that
get up on the mic.
Until they get weird those assholes who carry their assault rifles with them everywhere.
Oh, shit. Now that's topical for right now. Especially so in Arizona.
Right, fucking I-10 and
holy
shit.
Holy shit.
That's all close to home.
So, another
thing. Really, it's right there.
Yeah. We were driving on the I-10 on the way over here.
We started to drive onto it, and I was like, oh, I don't know. Yeah.
Ah, shit.
I know. I was waiting to be like, they're not here yet. And then be like, turn on the news, be like, oh, shit, that's Ken's car. What did I do?
Yeah, you're all texting them angrily, like, why the fuck aren't you
yeah,
here,
where are you,
you asshole?
Oh. God, what, you got shot in the face?
You better be dead.
Oh, oh my God. That's dark.
All right.
You know what? I'm not even mad.
Yeah. Another thing that is really fun until it gets weird is a beard longer than 12 inches.
Yeah. I mean, you could, like, initially,
it's
like
Gandalf and shit.
You're like, what's up, man? That's pretty cool. And then you start really getting into it.
To go that route. I was thinking about growing it out for a while, and I got about to here-ish, and I was like, no, fuck that shit. Trimmed it back.
My friend Dylan, when I used to serve, he's got a nice beard going. He keeps good care. He takes really good care of it.
It's so much work. Oh, my fucking God. That's why I was like, no, I'm keeping it short.
When you used to what?
Huh?
When I was a server
and a bartender at Olive Garden.
Okay. I thought you said when I served, like, you were in the military or something.
Get back.
Yeah, I've actually, like, I don't know. I've thought about it before, but I don't know.
All right. You can go to the Rangers where? Now.
Huh?
Where'd you serve? What restaurant?
Olive Garden.
which location?
It was over in Queen Creek on Ellsworth Loop.
Because the one over by Chandler Mall, not really happy with them.
Really? What happened?
We had a shitty server.
Break
really
it down.
Shitty.
Matt attracts shitty service at restaurants. I've determined this.
I used to be a fucking server, so I think that's
why. Were you a
shitty
server?
And then I fucking nitpick them. No, dude, come on. Me?
I was just asking. Karma's a bitch. That's all I was asking.
Dude, no.
I don't know.
Seems like, so what you're saying is you were a shitty server.
No, I was asking if he was a shitty server.
What I'm hearing is...
Dude, you heard me when we were in the car and I got the when I was on call.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Dude, I become like a...
No, I know. I know you're very professional. Well, I don't know. This could have been back in the teenager. thing. For all I know, maybe you're like, fuck, I should have been a dick, and now it's coming back to haunt me.
No, I was still friendly back
then. No, that's what I kind of figured. I just
sorry. Sorry, man.
No.
I apologize.
Yeah,
server stories.
All right. So another thing that is fun until it gets weird is advice from a wise old black man.
Like, at first, I'm like, okay, advice from a white...
Oh. You know, he's real.
Why gotta be black?
Why gotta be black?
Perfect example. You should just have a cappuccino and everything will be fine. Flip-flop, bibbidi-bop.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. You just added some more weight to that card.
That's what I do.
So, the next thing that is fun until it gets weird, and I can vouch for this one, is Stephen Mooney Jr.
Oh, fuck!
Yes.
Damn.
So, you know what? Right off the bat, I'm going
to say
that one wins.
It's got to win. Did you play it?
Yes. No. No.
Jesus.
You know why? Let me put it this way. What was in second place?
Wise old black man.
I'm fuck!
It's okay, Steven.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. I'm just coming up like, I'm like, it's like the
I was
going
to hang on to it until a brony question came up, but I was like, you know what? Bronies. Maybe a brony question isn't going to come up this time around.
It worked.
Blank. Just saying.
Is it hashtag just saying?
Yes. No, it's just, it's this. Blank. Just saying.
Oh, man.
I'm sorry, what?
Blank. Just saying.
Here's my card for you.
We pass that in with yours. Thank you.
Yeah,
okay,
I need to see what these ones are.
Oh my God, it finally happened.
Jamming.
I'm the Eric.
What happened?
Because I'm not winning. All right.
Prepare to grow six inches and.
Oh, wow. Okay.
He didn't mean
really
tall,
bad luck with cars.
Oh, man.
I didn't mean just tall.
Monkey torture. Just saying.
All right.
Making sweet, sweet love all night long. Just saying.
Just saying.
Just saying.
This might want just win because it's so douchey. Swag. Just saying.
That's like two hashtags right there. Hashtag swag, hashtag just saying.
A fluffy little butt. Just saying.
Just saying.
I like a fluffy little butt.
I don't know. I like.
I won't lie.
I like fluffy little butt, but swag is just so on the nose. Just swag. Just saying. Oh, hey, yeah, swag. Who had swag?
I had swag.
Okay, oh, fluffy,
give me that
fluffy little butt.
Give me that card.
Dude, I was so close. I had fluffy little butt.
Damn it.
Fuck, man.
I would assume you would have swag.
Oh, wait, I
no.
Matt actually has swag. I happen to have the swag card.
In a new novel by Nicholas Sparks, a young girl tragically falls in love with blank.
And I just don't have my white people almost kissing card.
Repeat the question, please.
Yeah, in a new novel by Nicholas Sparks, a young girl tragically falls in love with blank. Did you give me one?
Yeah, there I gave you. That's the one you're holding is mine.
Let me pass it on.
Yeah.
Is that all of them?
It's like the first person to give you a card.
Can't see that close. All right. Nicholas Sparks' new novel, A Girl Tragically Falls in Love with the Ooze. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
I was about to say, it's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 15.
Falls in love with the Great Cornholio.
Oh, shit.
She needs TP for her bunghole.
I need TP for my bunghole.
TP.
You, sir. I need
bunghole. The Itty Bitty Titty Committee.
Damn!
That's fucking funny.
It falls in love with autoerotic asphyxiation.
Asphyxiation.
We gotta go that little itty bitty titty committee.
Yes!
Fuck this, dude! Fuck
right,
that!
I have to ask, what was gonna be second?
Second? Probably Cornholio.
Woo!
Oh, was not what it's second.
Oh, okay. Right.
What are you at? Five?
I don't know. What am I at?
Eric's probably one.
Six. Yeah, six. Shit. What do we play to?
I think 10.
No, I thought it was 7.
Well, technically, well...
It depends on how much time we have. We've got plenty of time right now, so we're good to go.
Shit, well...
Well, it depends on how long we want to go.
Everybody else needs to step up this game. All right. Like the game.
But I can't win this round, so hey.
I need, like,
news,
a new
everybody.
Hand, I think.
You going to throw out
the well, what, wait until I read the question, because you lose your turn if you reboot the universe. So you might have one that can answer this question. If not, then you can reboot.
Matthew pound it.
Shoot.
No.
All right.
Fuck yeah, buddy.
Blank. Good to the last drop.
Don't even
now wishing your best.
Don't even care if it wins.
But you're wishing whoever played the almost three ounces of cum
yes,
earlier
was
wishing
mine,
they still had that.
Right.
That was yours.
Yes.
Of course it was.
You always think back to the ones that could have been.
Oh, you're talking about cards. I thought you were talking about my past sex life.
Oh God.
It's like,
oh
yeah.
But who am I missing? Who am I missing?
Do you want to reboot the universe?
You can choose to reboot the universe if you want to.
I think I'm going to.
All right. Do you have 12? Make sure you've actually drawn because you might be able to.
And so I just discard these?
Yeah, you just discard those. Yeah. Grab 12 new ones. You don't play this round, but you get 12 new cards.
Am I able to?
Not this. You can do it.
Next time?
You can do it on his turn.
Okay.
Because next turn you'll read.
Yeah. Sounds good.
All right. Blank. Good to the last drop. We got child abuse. Good to the last drop.
Damn!
Fuck! Ouch!
We got bullshit. Good to the last drop.
Damn right.
And we've got a drawing of Popeye playing poker.
Ooh,
good to
the last drop.
That one's good. It's that spinach, man.
Gotta go with child abuse.
Yes!
We got child abuse.
I didn't care because I was like, I get the Popeye card. I'm like, Popeye's a gangster. Yeah. Fuck it.
That is. I like that one though.
Well, blow me down.
Popeye seals his own fate.
Oh, I just. Drew
or one. Just blow me.
You have all to right, drink
now. That's it. Okay. Yellow.
He's strong to the finish because someone eats his spinach. So.
Shit.
All right. Probably so my card is
so
the.
Read into it.
My card is the blank. Spangled Banner.
Oh.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Fuck!
Drink!
I need to get more beer.
Can you grab me one?
Yeah, what do you want?
Please and thank you. I'll take another. Miller.
Miller Lite was a good choice then.
All right. I'll
yeah, for sure. This one. Definitely.
Oh.
We had Shock Talk last week, so it was kind of...
Sorry.
Well...
Fuck, man. It's because I was looking, I was like, I don't even know what these guys like, but I know they like this one, so I grabbed that one.
All right, guys, let's find out what type of spangled banner this is.
I love that, like, my negativity is so out of the ordinary.
All right. So the first one is the South Spangled Banner. And then we have the Yeast Spangled Banner.
I don't want to fuck around with that. Trust me. Did you know that could happen? I'm just warning you in advance. If it does, some tough acting to Nacton, knock that shit right out. Don't ask me how I know.
Ben Gay too.
I'm just telling you.
Oh, God.
I'm not putting Ben Gay anywhere near that. Are you insane? The fuck's wrong with you? Fucking sadist.
All right.
Holy shit.
Then we have the Keanu Reeves Spangled Banner.
Like, whoa. I know Kung Fu. Stars and Stripes. Whoa.
Whoa.
Oh, say, can you see
from the dawn's, like, early lights? Excellent.
And then we have the Some Goddamn Peace and Quiet Spangled Banner. I think I might have to go with the Goddamn Peace and Quiet. That's pretty funny.
That's a good one.
Yes!
No,
really?
Kicking ass in
this,
dude, this
is bullshit.
I love this game, guys.
All right, so I can redo the universe. Or
if you want to, you probably want to wait until you reach the question, just in case you have like the perfect answer. But if you don't want to, then that's
fine
too.
Sounds good.
All righty. So we have blank. Kid tested, mother approved. Nope.
This is from the movie Twister.
Wait, the song. The song. I thought you were like telling me your card you have. You're like, this is from the movie. I'm like, why are you telling me?
The song.
I had no idea. I can't remember. Did you see Twister in theaters?
I don't. Possibly.
I did.
This is the game adults.
I did. Oh, that's right. Oh, yeah.
Twister was awesome.
It was a good movie.
Cow.
I guess you could say there
another
was
cow.
A.
Love that movie.
I guess you could say.
I think it's the same cow.
I think you could say, what a twist.
What a twist.
What a twist. I've been saying that. Remember, I was
keep
saying
doing that
last week.
From Robot Chicken.
Yeah.
What a twist!
There was some movie I read that they
he
wanted.
Just had a movie come out today too.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
Hey, babe, what was the question?
What was this movie? God damn it! Midnight Shyamalan, Ding Dong, and a movie.
No. It's the, I got new cards.
Okay, so you're not in this round, right? Is that correct?
It's called The Visit
because you rebooted.
Oh, I gotcha.
Oh,
all right, sweet.
All right.
That's cool.
So we have.
Ooh.
Let's.
Man, after my own heart.
I just gotta say, this hand is so much better.
There you go.
What a twist. So, we have The Unbelievable World of Mushrooms. Kid tested, mother approved.
Fuck
like,
yes.
I didn't know where that was going until the very end. I was like, all right.
Mom, this cereal's the good best.
Of course mom approves.
This pizza's just amazing.
Why
mom,
is there
why do you have such sharp teeth?
Like Zoinks, man.
I love Scooby.
All right, so the next one is a dance move that's just sex. Kid tested, mother approved.
Oh, man, I'm going to have to use that up at the
If the
clubs.
Next card is an Oedipus complex, we've got some problems.
Yeah. All right, so
well, that's
I'm not
nice
quite
here.
Sure how to do this, but I will try. Kid tested, mother approved.
Wookiee!
Chewbacca noise.
Shut up, you big furry elf. I don't care what you smell in there.
This is a really tough one. I think I'm going to have to go with a dance move that's just sex.
That's fucking hilarious.
Yeah!
Really?
Yeah, you just missed it. Eric won again. This game is rigged.
Damn. You are destroying right now.
This is the first time ever that I've, like, even
you know I'm gonna laugh so you know I'm gonna
like
laugh
this.
So hard if
don't worry,
if
he
the
paid
show
us before the show.
Well, I was gonna
so.
Laugh so hard if the show didn't record.
I'm like,
so no one would believe Eric's victory. Oh shit!
He's all double checking.
I'm like, yeah. I'm like, seriously. Like, I'm gonna check. I'm gonna check now.
Man, good for you, man. Just enjoy it while it lasts.
All right.
It won't happen
what?
Again.
What will I bring back in time to convince the people that I am a powerful wizard?
I have the perfect one for this.
What shall I bring back in time? I'm a wizard.
We pass this down, man.
I'm pretty sure if I just came back in time, they saw the DeLorean, I'd be like, done.
Back
I just
in
got
time.
Another really good one.
Stop.
Don't look. Don't look.
Man,
damn it. And then
decision.
I broke the rule and I looked and it was a good one, too.
I kind of.
You guys.
Sorry. Oh. Sex.
Matthew, I guess you can say it.
What a twist.
What a twist.
I think this one's going to
I read somewhere that he turned down a movie at some point because.
Yeah, because it was like.
We wanted to have a twist. And like, he was like, if I direct this movie, people are going to expect a twist and then they're going to be let down because there's no twist.
No, they were all like, we want to do a biopic. He's like, no thanks.
That's the twist.
Okay. What will I bring back in time to convince people that I'm a powerful wizard? I love trying to read this. We really need more mic stands now. Roland the Farter, Flatuous to the King. I don't know who Roland the Farter is, though.
He's Flatuous to the King.
Yes. which I just...
Duh, heard. Steve.
A banana, you know, for scale.
Ah, Reddit reference. Like it. All right.
Banana.
And Coltler's far-right-leaning dildo.
Oh, fuck that bitch. Seriously.
And important news about Taylor Swift. I'm trying to figure out who Ann Coltler is. I think it is.
Coltler, I think, is
that it?
Coltler? Yeah, she's a stupid bitch that gets on TV and spouts some insane bullshit.
Do you hate her?
I do hate her quite a bit.
Is this a
ruse? I don't know her very well. Actually, I don't know her as a person, but the
I'm
shit
sure
she says
this
on
is
TV
a ruse or not.
Just pick whichever is funniest. It doesn't matter.
I want to pick this one, but I'm afraid now.
Which one?
The dildo one.
You should just go with it then. Go with your first instinct.
Go with your instincts.
The dildo
go with your guts.
For the win!
I wasn't the dildo. I was Taylor Swift.
You were I was going to be the second choice.
I need the black one.
Yeah, you got to give her the right card.
Well, Matthew. She said she needed the black one.
You want me to hand it to her or something?
Matthew.
Oh.
Okay.
We need a sitcom laugh track.
No.
So this is fun. I like this game.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Yeah. I was like...
Matt's like, wait, what? No?
Yeah, I actually...
Are you guys,
going
to take off?
I have the starter set. I just haven't had a party over here to do it, so...
No, dude, be down to fucking play this some more. Fuck yeah, we have to get this game, babe. I like this.
Amazon. And you don't go to Amazon. You go to thesasquatch.net, click on the Amazon banner, and shop like you normally do.
You do.
Yeah.
It doesn't cost you a penny more.
But I believe we do.
Okay,
that
cool.
That link, yeah.
Awesome.
Guys, I need to have a talk with you.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know, I was just going over the books, and... I noticed there's a $2,100 charge labeled blank in the expense reports. Can you guys explain that?
Hey, Matthew, you got into character. I love it.
That was good.
I have a good one for this one.
I don't
dark.
Even know.
It's dark.
Well, I'm an accountant, so I can be pretty dark,
me
too.
Me too.
Right, yeah, you're talking to...
There you go, buddy.
That's all we do.
That's what we do all day, every day.
Numbers.
$2,100 charge, huh? Is that all?
$1,200.
Oh. It's even less.
All right. The charge is labeled genital piercings. Come on,
yeah.
You guys. We want a very profitable business.
$1,200 worth of genital piercings?
That's a lot of piercings.
What?
Except for one? Except for one person?
That's like Jacob's ladder.
I was just
going to
say, it's one Jacob's ladder, guys, okay?
A charge for $1,200 for firm buttocks. Firm buttocks, you guys?
Hey, it's got to go with the Jacob's ladder, man. Come on.
You got to look sexy. Come on now.
$2,100 for...
I can't be carrying around all this hardware with a flabby butt.
You spent $1,200 to poop in public?
Look, when you poop in public in front of a church.
That was the fine. That was the fine. For what?
Dead parents?
All right, bad.
That's the dark one.
Now, if it was
my parents are dead, so put it on the books.
How much is Bruce Wayne worth? $21 billion? It should have been $21 billion. Then it would be dead parents.
Actually, it would be more like, where is it?
What kind of hitman could you hire for $1,200 that would kill two people?
Where's
no, seriously,
money?
Where can you
Batman
find
Batman sad.
Where can you find this?
Batman depressed. My girlfriend died and I took a return.
All right. I know yours.
Yeah. Damn.
But there's another one I want to pick, and I almost don't want to pick it because I have a feeling it's going to be fucking Eric's.
I'm pretty sure he's going to pick
why is,
the one
why is
that's
it always,
not Eric's.
Why does it matter whose it is? Just pick the one you like, man.
Because we don't like you.
And
Eric, you can't
silent
cry.
Tear rolls down
Shit.
His cheek.
All right, I'm going Firm Buttocks. Yes. Fuck, dude, I knew it.
God damn.
I fucking
what
knew that
gonna,
was going to happen.
What was the other one you were debating?
God damn it, dude.
It was genital piercings, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't.
It was pooping in public?
Yeah.
Damn it! Pooping in public made the most sense, actually, because like you could have to pay a fine if you did that.
Fuck that. All I know, if this was golf, I'd be winning.
Shit.
I've just got to like revel in this because this is like the only time this happened.
Good for you, Eric.
Ever.
Shit.
Oh, shit. Hey, be thankful you didn't draw this card to read.
That is it.
All right.
It's probably one about me.
There we go. 2 a.m. in the city that never sleeps. The door swings open, and she walks in, legs up to here. Something in her eyes tells me she's looking for blank.
Whoa. I really wish I had a different one, but...
I was like instant. Like, here's the card! I've got it!
Hers probably just says the D.
Shit,
that would be so great. Oh my God, that would so win, probably.
That would
I'm
fucking
so sorry. What
be
happened?
Amazing.
I'm so sorry.
The D. The D happened.
Just for Matt.
I just didn't hear the question.
Shit. 2 a.m. in the city that never sleeps.
Who's...
This is a cover.
But who's singing it?
Not Metallica. I know that.
No, I know that. That's what I was like, oh, shit.
So it's obviously a cover because it's not Metallica.
Oh, shit. It's Lissy.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
I like it.
Totally.
This right, was True Detective Season 1, I think this was.
I should probably watch that.
I saw that. I didn't hear this
Or maybe
song,
it was Season 2. It was
if it was Season 2, I haven't seen that yet.
Okay.
So. I'm waiting for it all to be done so I can just watch.
You, Eric, and your fucking.
I'm sorry.
Bullshit.
Okay, let's. I'm sorry.
Are you ready, Matt?
Yeah.
Matt.
Yes.
All right. Put yourself.
2 a.m. in the city that never sleeps. The door swings open and she walks in, legs up to here. Something in her eyes tells me she's looking for blank.
Oh, dude, that's so rad. I'm sorry I didn't listen the first time.
Right.
Shit.
And I told her I was Don Knotts.
No, that's not Don Knotts. It's fuck. Inspector Gadget.
Inspector Gadget. Go Gadget Arm.
Inspector.
Oh God, what's his
go,
name?
Go Gadget Penis.
Go Gadget Penis. No, oh, fuck. What's the guy's name? He's in Get Smart and everything. He's gonna bug the fuck out of me now.
Matthew Broderick.
No. No, not that abomination.
Oh, the
actual Get Smart show. Shit.
Yeah, wasn't he the?
But he was the voice of Inspector Gadget on the original series. Go,
first
Gadget.
First card's kind of gross.
Huh?
All right. So
I'll get you next 2 time, Gadget.
In the city that never sleeps, door swings open and she walks in. Legs up to here. Something in her eyes tells me she's looking for vaginal discharge that smells like a fresh Reuben sandwich.
Ew!
Oh, my God.
That is so gnarly.
Shit.
Yes. That was
so
awesome.
That is so gnarly.
Something in her eyes Reuben. Tells me she's looking for... The female orgasm. It's a myth, guys. It's a myth. Trust me.
You'd think that.
Something in her eyes tells me she's looking for a meat popsicle.
Oh.
Yes.
Very close to the D.
Oh, that was kind of like the D, yeah.
Yeah.
Or is she looking for the Chronic? If it wasn't for all these
I'd
great cards,
like
the Chronic would be a great
chronic.
Choice for this. But, all right, who's got the vaginal discharge that smells like a fresh Reuben sandwich?
Yeah! Yes!
That's too good.
I've got two. Y'all better watch out.
Uh-oh.
Drop it like it's Eric.
I've got two.
How many do you have?
Oh, what is that?
It's
zero?
Zero.
This that's one would have been
that's
perfect.
He's indicating.
Do it, wait, do it again.
Sure.
I'm diving!
Oh, what are you, the lion from Madagascar 3?
Too soon.
How's that too soon?
I don't know. I haven't seen that one.
What? Bryan Cranston. Yeah, he's fucking in that.
All right. Did you see the Penguins?
No, I didn't see that.
It's closing in on time, so we'll probably need to make it one more round. I started with me, so we'll end with you.
Oh, so you can...
So,
more points.
Yeah. That's how it works.
Claim his victory.
He's like, yeah.
If you want,
you know what? Cards Against Humanity is going to become like Monopoly. Fuck this game! I quit!
I'm done!
It's 4 a.m, Grandma!
You're like, well, Sonny, you should have paid attention to your economics class!
I'm going to cut your head off with this little fucking dog.
Oh, that's... Wow.
Hey, that's how my grandma would have wanted it.
All right, so...
Who's up? You?
That was the
question. No, I just did this game. You won with line. So it's her turn.
Oh, my bad, dog.
Yes.
Okay, you need to find where she said that, because we're going to use that as a drop now.
Yeah, that was rad.
That's going to go right with, ha ha, bird!
What's the time?
I need to find that one.
What's the timestamp on that?
Yay.
About 1:35.
All right.
1:35.
Cool.
All right. So this is a twofer.
Oh, twofer.
All right. So step one, blank. Step two, blank. Step three, profit.
Of course.
I don't even think this is going to work, but...
Which order, though? I know these are the cards, but I don't know which order is best.
Eric, it doesn't really matter because you're probably right.
Yeah, I know. That's
okay. All right, we're going with this one. We're going with this order.
You probably stack them.
Yeah, that's what I'm going with. Oh. I caught it. I got it. All right, guys. So the first one. Step one, irony. Step two, being a dinosaur. Step three, profit.
All right. Okay.
All right. Step one, prancing. Step two, the reek of shame.
Well.
And step three, profit.
Shouldn't it actually be step three, ellipsis, and step four is profit? I mean, if they're going to do the South Park reference, they should do it right.
Right? All right. This one, step one, Lady Gaga.
Oh, I don't like where this is going already.
Right. Step two, David Bowie flying on a tiger made of lightning.
Fuck, okay, that wins.
It turned around.
It turned around.
That was pretty awesome. Oh, this
Have you heard of the Babe?
The Babe.
The Babe with the power.
Power.
Oh my god, that is like my favorite movie of all fucking time. I love that movie.
I'm talking about the Babe.
All right.
Are you talking about the Babe in your pants? What the fuck, man? What is that thing?
No, that's a cod piece.
Oh.
Dude, that's classic, man.
Oh, come on. Okay, that's our closing. So.
It's a big, bright, shining star.
Oh, yeah,
that
we can do that for
sure. Pretty
sure
that's the same prosthetic Marky Mark used in.
What? No. What? No. So, no. What? I think we found a Transformer. What? No.
I think we found a Transformer.
All right, last one. Step one, a urine-filled bong, which is disgusting.
What? No.
True.
Step two, passing a kidney stone.
Ooh, wow, that's been going around at work, though.
Wow. Dude, no freaking
really
has. Like, that's like an epic fucking demic.
Dude, I have a fucking kidney, I might have a kidney infection. Yeah, I just found out that I have fluid in my joint. The past year, I think I've had a torn ACL.
Damn.
And my doctor thought it was something completely different and gave me a steroid injection into my knee and everything.
We got you covered now. Go to her GoFundMe page so she, because she's dying.
Yeah. I'm dying. Yeah. Help.
She's literally dying of urine-filled bong. I mean, kidney stone.
Shit, that's pretty hardcore.
First off, that's a different evening in Vegas, okay?
Yeah. So imagine, you're like filling the urine bong, right? And then pass the kidney stone right in there.
Ouch. Just never lose the bet to drink the bong water after.
Oh,
herpes!
Like, I'm choking on the stone. I'm choking on your kidney stone. You
it's
son
just
of a
like
bitch.
Herpes. Been there.
Never playing truth or dare with you
no
again.
No fun.
All right, so I'm thinking the urine-filled bong and kidney stone is probably the funniest one. That or
nobody's
the
gonna laugh now when people that
yes!
work like
did he get a urine-filled bong?
Yes! Really?
You just fucked up.
Did I?
Because you were going to pick what next?
Lady Gaga and David
you
Bowie.
Done fucked up.
You done fucked up.
Oh.
It was a hard decision.
It's
really
rare
was.
That you have two cards
Lady
in your hand
Gaga
that go together.
And
I'm sorry, you're
Bowie flying in on
stone.
A fucking lightning tiger?
Tiger
that
on.
Is profits right there.
That is
the lightning tiger,
profit.
It is.
That's
I give
amazing.
You that. I give you that. It's just, I don't know. I had a tough time.
Have you heard of the bong?
What bong?
The bong filled with
the
urine.
Bong.
What urine? The urine with kidney stones.
Oh no.
Hell yeah.
Uh-oh.
All right.
Hashtag fuck my life.
Oh, is it my turn?
Oh, right. Ken's like, I've been out. I don't care.
Yeah, whatever.
Dude, it's like, did that shit last year with the fantasy.
Normally, we barely even like pay attention to the score at all until like the very end. It's like, oh, hey.
Yeah, they're pissed at me. I didn't set my team yesterday.
And
I know, for once. I think I won one. I tied with one of the guests like one other time. I think that's the closest I've ever come to winning. I'm like,
no, this is pretty fun. I like this. It's fucking hilarious.
It's good shit. All right, what do we got?
Right. All right, what
so,
you got
guys,
for us?
You guys have got to check this dude out. All right, he just put out a book. It's now in bookstores called The Audacity of Blank by Barack Obama. You know, he's our president, so.
People in the United States, I like to pass kidney stones and bongs.
And,
true story.
Now you sound like a pilot.
Well, that's what he talks like. It's basically a pilot. Basically Obama is a pilot mixed with Yogi Bear.
Yeah.
You know, what we need to do? We need to stop the ranger from picking our picnic baskets.
That was actually really spot on. Holy shit.
Oh, why did I look?
Because because you're a bitch.
He's going to win the game.
I would have won with that card for sure.
All right. So, this great new book, now in bookstores, called The Audacity of Genghis Kong, Cocklord of the Mongols, by Barack Obama.
Oh, did he say those things?
That's pretty good.
One alone is very weak. You put a whole bundle together.
All over your face, neck, and chest. Zakadu.
Oh, all right, shit. Our next book, now in stores, called The Audacity of a Death Ray by Barack Obama.
That kind of fits.
Once I'm out of the White
House. Barack Obama, not Elon Musk, okay? Yeah. Jeez.
Once I'm out of the White House, I'm going to kill some bitches.
Kill some bitches. kill some bitches and smoke my urine bomb.
Fucking Republicans that be talking shit about me. Going to be George, throwing them.
George W. Bush, you're on my list.
Fuck. Why's that happening? Dad. That's a damn nuclear.
Dad, we got to get to Mars. Nuclear. He's coming after me.
Nuclear.
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 So these nuclear. All right. So now on bookstores, The Audacity of Exploding Pigeons, man.
Oh, I like that one. I hate
Does it have a man in there?
You ever read
like Exploding
Tesla?
Pigeons, man?
No,
dude.
There's no man in there. I had to add it. I felt it needed it. It wasn't
like it was
man.
So much better with that. I was like, is that seriously on the card? That's awesome.
Like, man, he's like exploding pigeons.
I appreciate
man.
Your ad-lib because that works. That works.
You so better weird. Pass the urine bong, dude.
Yeah. Like, dude, I totally saw that pigeon explode, man.
Dude, I'm so high, man.
You have no idea.
Fucking urine bong, man. It's the kidney stones, bro.
The pigeon came over and talked to me first, man. He told me, like, dude, I'm going to explode.
I was president.
Then he fucking exploded, man. You were president? Wait, what?
You were so serious.
Matthew's like,
I'm the president. Fuck you all. I'm the president.
All right, so the last and not least, now in bookstores, The Audacity of an Interracial Handshake by Barack Obama.
We can demonstrate that now.
Oh, my gosh, it happened.
Oh, shit. No, I feel like people, this just
the audacity
happened.
Being presented
did.
Right here in this room.
I feel like this audacity to record.
Carries some weight, but unfortunately,
you don't
I'm
have the audacity.
Gonna have to go with Genghis Khan.
That was me.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, Genghis Khan, beat you so bad.
All right.
He'll put a dick in your bong.
You should see how he swings.
Yeah, I thought that one was pretty fucking funny.
Genghis Khan is a worthy victor.
You make a fake a wall. I make a bong.
Okay, so this is my card. This is obviously the last. The rest go.
Oh, yeah, apparently no. I don't exist.
Oh, this is perfect because I was actually going to have you read this card.
Oh, all right.
So this is perfect then.
All right.
So don't worry.
Oh,
for our penultimate question.
So do I have to read it like?
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Uh-oh.
I love this song.
I fucking love this song, too. This song is badass. The beat is badass. And I don't give a shit.
Yeah.
Rihanna fucking kills it on this track. And anybody that hates it, you can go fucking suck a dick.
William Shatner.
shocking new autobiography is titled Blank, The Final Frontier.
That worked, then that worked out, man.
Yeah. That was yeah. very good.
That was really...
Oh, dude, I do like so many. This is what happens when you have no life.
Oh, we know, Steve. We see you at work.
Yeah. I sit in a cubicle. Very small.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and ask you to read that one more time.
Just four more times. That's
four
all.
More times. One more time.
William Shatner. Shocking new autobiography. Title is Blank, The Final Frontier. Come to my world, Ken.
You and your voices fucking amaze me. Seriously, we'll be like outside a smoke break or whatever, I fucking die.
Brannigan's Law.
Loves that Brannigan's Law. Oh my god.
It's pronounced champagne.
No.
Yeah. Champagne. It's pronounced champagne.
Oh god.
Oh, yeah. Oh god.
Oh god.
Gif, tell the boy to put out my FOMO shorts. The boy. You put out my FOMO shorts.
Fucking awesome.
Fucking Gif, man.
And it's like, the jackass wants to see you now. All right.
I have had sex with a woman. Inform the men.
Yeah. Gif, I've made it with a woman. Inform the men. Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Where are they going? Oh.
They're gone six. William Shatner's shocking new autobiography is titled A Passion Latino Lover, The Final Frontier. It really is. William Shatner's shocking new autobiography is titled Poking a Fatty on Facebook. The Final Frontier.
That's gold.
The Final Frontier.
William Shatner's shocking new autobiography title is Scrotal Frostbite, The Final Frontier.
Oh. Ow.
Beat me up, antibiotics.
Need more than antibiotics to fix that.
William Shatner's
need that donation
shocking
of
new autobiography is titled Warm Velvety Muppet Sex, The Final Frontier.
That sounds so great after the thought of scrotal frostbite.
I would take that over the scrotal frostbite. I don't know why, but I have a feeling he actually would make a book of this one, Poking a Fatty on Facebook.
That's a good one. Yes, he knew it. You called it.
And that so called it, too, which is fine. I was like, oh, come on now. Don't look at me.
I did
right
lie. Okay, who was passionate Latino lover, though? Because that was good.
What a twist.
What a twist.
What a twist.
Now, Kermit, get over here and give me a Muppet job.
Hi-ho, no.
Woo. All right, guys.
I wonder
best
what would
ever.
I wonder what would break first.
All right.
Everybody's spirit
the,
or
the final question.
And it's a twofer.
Oh, a twofer.
Twofer.
Even better.
Oh, God, the twofers.
I like how I'm like about to play the cards we just played. Like, all right, let's see what I got in my hand here.
You're like, wait, I just
wait a minute.
These.
These look familiar.
Oh, the one I just got's gold.
Heed my voice, mortals.
Ooh, shit.
I am the god of blank, and I will not tolerate blank.
Shit, that was class.
The god
I'm
of
telling you,
blank
this is gold.
Won't tolerate blank.
Oh, it's two.
Oh.
Two.
It's a twofer.
Two.
Hear my voice, mortals. I am the god of blank, and I will not tolerate blank. I am the god of blank, and I will not tolerate blank.
I don't know if this is even going to work, but yeah.
What do I have to lose?
Got one really great card for this and not another one to go with it.
You know what, Eric? No one cares. We get it.
Sorry. Gosh.
So this podcast thing's pretty fucking cool. How long have you guys been doing this?
Since the dawn of time.
In its current form, oh. About 2 years.
Let's do Eric's logical answer.
The whole setup's
answer.
Really fucking cool, dude.
Not my cool like story that I was going to give, like a backstory where I fought orcs and dragons, but Eric's like, no, 2 years.
I fought a dragon.
Dick.
Oh, man.
He's not even listening. Right.
There you go. What? No? Who fought a dragon?
Oh, nothing. No.
I fought a dragon.
I think this is the
worst. I have Dragon Age
I fought a fucking dragon paladin deck earlier that was pissing me the fuck off in Hearthstone.
Yeah.
Eric is urine-filled bong. Infects kidney stones.
Infects kidney stones. That's
slightly under 3 ounces of cum.
Exactly.
Heed my voice, man.
Well, it has to be slightly under because if you hit that 3-ounce mark, you can't take it on the airplane. TSA fucking regulation. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, that's my right. God. That's so funny. Yes. That is fucking hilarious.
Because that would create a hell of an explosion.
Oh, my God.
Heed my voice, mortals. I am the god of the entire internet, and I will not tolerate a rug that really ties a room together.
Oh, man, that had such potential.
Whoa.
Oh, people, if you could see his face.
Oh, that's good stuff.
That rug that really tied the room together.
Oh, he's like, I just want to make sure.
Not this time.
You're not going to win this one.
I'm the god of her dry, scaly hands.
Ew.
That sucks.
And I will not tolerate an empty, neutered ball sack.
Wow, that ties into what we were doing earlier.
Oh my god!
I know somebody else who could use a testy donation.
No, we were making jokes about Lance Armstrong earlier.
Yeah. Matt said something about having four balls, and we're like, well, you could like donate a couple of those to people in need, like Lance Armstrong.
Dude, I hear they pay fucking bank for that shit.
For balls?
Yeah.
Fuck, I can live with one.
Every guy in here just kind of looked up and went, ooh.
Wait, what?
I'm
going to keep my balls. Yeah,
my balls.
Everybody's got a price.
Hey, I've had balls. Mine for 36 years.
They're not helping me at all. They're
I just can live with
there.
One. I mean, if they're paying top dollar.
Dude, first off, the kids are just going down the drain anyway, so.
Tissue box.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
I'm like, hey, check this out. Children's tears.
Children's tears.
Slightly under 3 ounces.
I'm the god of scrotum tickling. And I will not tolerate a slack-jawed yokel.
Well, there goes
But when you tickle my scrotum, I turn into a slack-jawed
yokel. Damn right, because I'm the god of scrotum tickling.
I should be like, oh, yeah. Oh,
that feels good.
Oh, Lord.
That feels good.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, that feels good.
Oh, see, it's too bad we couldn't mix and match them. The scrotum, or the empty scrotum and the tickling.
There you go.
Yeah. I am the god of tickling scrotums, and I will not tolerate an empty one, damn it.
Yes.
This one's a little meta, though.
Moo.
Oh.
That was a big word.
I'm the god of being worshipped as the one true god.
Oh, shit.
That's like
shit
Kanye.
Shit just got real.
That's like Kanye.
Mic drop.
That's like... Mic drop.
We don't actually drop the mics because
they're
actually
I'm
very sensitive
let you
pieces
finish,
of equipment and kind of expensive, so...
I am the
please,
god.
Every time
don't
I see somebody actually drop a mic, I'm like, ah!
I'll reel myself.
Don't do that!
We gotta hear that one again. Go.
I am the god of being worshipped as the one true god, and I will not tolerate sudden penis loss. That is the winner!
Yes!
Fuck you!
Dude!
Damn.
Woo! That was a good one, though.
What was that, like 30?
What was second place?
Oh, I'm not good like you out there.
Yeah, what was
apologize.
Second place?
That's right.
Oh, second place?
Ball sack.
Hashtag empty ball sack
scrotum tickling.
Hey, we're gonna get that shit trending. Everyone, come on.
I like her dry, scaly hands. Was that yours?
No.
Right here, baby.
Was it?
Right
good. That one's good too because, like, you know.
Oh my goodness.
Dry, scaly hands,
oh
and like,
my goodness.
You get close to, like, you know, it's all about masturbation.
Yeah.
And that's what I was thinking about.
Not tolerate.
It's masturbatory.
An empty.
Oh my goodness! It's all over her face,
you know.
Neck, and chest.
You can tell there's four dudes
I enjoyed
in the
this
room.
Game.
Fuck you.
Of course you did. Congratulations, by the way.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I appreciate
all
it.
Hail
so,
Eric awesome. In his
so we'll put it this way. America, if you don't want the terrorists to win, don't let Eric win again.
Well,
no, congratulations. It's
I was pretty excited my first time. I got 5 cards.
Hey,
nice.
Hey,
that's good.
Hey,
that's good.
Hey, Eric, way I'll put it this way.
How many did you end up with?
What's he had one.
One? All right.
Two.
One very, very badass one.
Yeah.
I don't remember what it was.
But Eric,
but
I'll put
badass.
It this way. Look,
it was the
you just
best
got a car.
One here,
you
so.
Just won Cards Against Humanity. You know what that's called? Everything's coming up Milhouse.
All right. It means I'm due for some shit luck, huh?
Probably.
Motherfucker. I think I already got that when my car exploded, and now I'm, you know, so I'm like
oh, dude, that's
picking
not...
up for that. Well, it didn't quite explode. No, it just... It overheated to the point where it fried the engine completely.
Yeah.
Like, it got that hot that fast that, like, just my effort to get it off the freeway completely seized the engine.
Oh, shit.
Had a Viking.
Which is why I have a new car. It's not really a new car. What? It's actually a year older than the car that I had before.
What did you have before?
A 2001 Taurus.
Wow.
Ford.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, high five. We both had a Taurus.
I have a 2005 silver Kia. Nice. Kia.
I almost ended up with a Kia, but when a friend of mine went to test drive it for me because I was at work, and he said that every time he shifted, there was a loud clunk.
Really?
And we're like, yeah, we're not buying that car.
Yeah.
My car, it needs a new motor mount. So when you try to go really fast, it tries to sound like a badass. So it gets really loud.
So it sounds like a cat, Eric?
Yes.
I hate you and I'm going to kill you in your sleep. Oh, no, that's my impression of a cat. Sorry, my bad.
Man, what kind of cats do you have?
Yeah.
All of them.
Remember?
They're evil.
Cunt cat.
I had about 8 billion of them. Right. Remember that? Oh, shit, fuck. I'm so glad I don't have a cat now.
Oh, shit, fuck?
Oh, shit, fuck.
Oh,
hashtag,
shit,
oh, shit, fuck, kittens.
All right. Guys, we should probably go ahead and wrap this up for this evening.
That's what she said.
One more time. Tell people where they can find your GoFundMe. I get confused all the different fundraising sites they have. You're using GoFundMe specifically, so how can they find you?
I am using GoFundMe, and you can find it. It's GoFundMe.com, against all odds, with underscores separating the words.
Against odds, underscore. Sorry, I thought I had to.
Oh,
I'm
no,
like
you're
hype
fine.
Man over here.
And then also, I do have my Twitter. I just got it, so I'm still kind of slow at Twitter, but it's
no worries.
It's girls.
Been on there for a few years. Still,
Eric Matthew has one tweet going. Why did I join the 4i Radio Network?
But that's Girls Game 2. It's GURLZ Game and the number 2. Anything helps. Thank you guys again for having me on here.
No,
I really
thanks
appreciate
for coming.
It.
Appreciate
it's
it.
So much pretty fun. Awesome. And it's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, and you guys are welcome back anytime.
Absolutely. I'll definitely be
we'll
back.
We'll never be back.
Yeah, no, that's
we're just going to leave
that's for that's why I always tell people, like, you guys, if you had a good time, you're welcome to come back. They're like, yeah, sure. And I'm like, I haven't heard from that person in a year.
No, we will.
They both quit their jobs so they don't have to see you at work.
No, this is
they move out
a
of state just
here.
In case they accidentally run into one of us somewhere.
That's true.
They
no,
had
for
their
real,
face.
Though, you guys have been fun. This has been the most fun that I've had in a long time.
Fuck cool. Yeah, dude. Yeah. Hell yeah.
You don't get out much, do you?
No.
No.
No, he does. They do. They do. They go to work and then they come home.
Yeah.
And we sleep. Or play video games.
Their life is like mine.
I know that feel, bro. I know that feel.
Oh, right in the feels. Yeah.
Right
in the feels.
In the feels.
All right. Well, thank you guys for once again having us. And
absolutely.
We'll be back.
Definitely.
And awesome. Next time, I am going to win. So,
you guys get ready.
Dude,
I accept your challenge.
Challenge
you know what?
Accepted.
I'm just going to say, we'll put this challenge out. Who wants to place bets on who's going to win next?
Oh, I got,
I'll
I got
win.
Five on it.
We'll let the audience decide. And if right. and if
how about who's going to fucking win in fantasy football this week?
Motherfucker over there. It's me versus
shit.
Matt this week.
Oh
yeah.
Bum, bum.
Who do you think is going to win?
Projection has you up by 15 points right now.
But that doesn't mean anything.
You got Eric
what are you feeling? What are you feeling?
I'm going to fucking kick your ass. That's what I'm feeling.
You got Eric Dewey here who runs the network and the board and the thing with the bang and the bang and the boom. And then you got Matthew here who's a great trainer done when you know Brett Favre, but he got the bang and the bottom thing. So, there's going to be great football.
Gonna be fun.
All right. on that note, Madden, why don't you tell us what we can do until next week, folks?
You better tap that track with the bing and the bong and the boom.
Fuck this shit, I'm out. Fuck this shit, I'm out. Don't mind me. I'ma just grab my stuff and leave. Excuse me, please. Fuck this shit, I'm out.
Nope.
Fuck this shit, I'm out.
All right then.
I don't know what the fuck just happened, but I don't really care. I'ma get the fuck up out of here.
Fuck this shit, I'm out.